It didn't work out. They went through some lean years. He feels a sense of urgency. He's trying to pass that on to his team. They have the best record in the NBA. They have the home court advantage throughout. So it's up to them to take care of the business at hand.
Jay Godottle, Lee Jones, and Tommy Wood, the man in charge of this game. Rod Strickland, we had to wait right before the start of this game. It was a game-time decision whether he could go with a bad ankle.
Having a great year. Rod Strickland playing sensational ball. In fact, Rick Adelman said before the game, without Rod Strickland, they probably would be under 500 on the season. That's the contributions that he has made, especially with the injury to Clyde Drexler.
Mark West out to Barkley, and here is Kevin Johnson, who's not been playing in back-to-back games. He's been held out of three of the last six, and will be held out when they play back-to-back this weekend. Marley with a three. That's a pretty good start for this Phoenix team that was not shooting well Monday night.
That's the identification again of the three-point shooters early in the ballgame. Look for Kevin Johnson to find Marley, then Ainge will come into the ballgame. They will play them together.
Boy, they started miserably Monday night, 13 points, shooting only 29% against the Houston Rockets. Buck Williams doesn't get it. Sabonis with the rebound. KJ, who has missed 29 games this year due to injury, plus two others due to that suspension. Sabonis slicing to the basket. Buck Williams comes away with the rebound. Here comes Strickland. Boy, he's been a model citizen this year for this Portland team. After wearing out, he's welcome in San Antonio and New York. Mark Bryant, who started the last 21 games for this Portland team, misses on the follow. 3-0. The Suns on the strength of that three-pointer by Dan Marley. The Suns are hitting almost five threes a game, attempting over 13.
Inside the post to Charles Barkley. No double team, so Barkley will step back and take the shot.
Didn't Rick Adelman say they were going to run at him early?
Well, they're going to wait to see what he does, to see if he looks for his shot early. You see him going quickly to the basket rather than looking for the pass.
5-0. Barkley able to hit it off the blocks. Here's Porter's had such a steady year for this Portland team, averaging over 18 points a game, and he hits a two. And so the Blazers are on the board. 5-2 Phoenix. Seven straight wins for Portland here at home. They are 30-10, but the Suns come in with the best record in the NBA. They come in at 26-13. Barkley again. I think they're going to have to double him now.
Well, the decision now will be made, and Rick Adelman will have to decide we're going to go get the ball out of his hands. You don't want to open up the three-point shooting, but Barkley looking to score now rather than to pass.
Rod Strickland follows again, missing both times. Out it comes to Kevin Johnson. Breakaway to Sabonis. This is what he does so well, is finish in the open floor.
Well, the importance of Barkley on the defensive backboard, he's a sixth leading rebounder in the NBA, so he rebounds, and now Sabonis is out flying on the wing. Quick outlet pass to Kevin Johnson.
Well, the Suns are off to a very effective start, 9-2, and what a difference it is when you have Barkley in the lineup. That is a three by Porter. Porter has just been one of the stabilizers this year because of all the injuries. He's been hitting 41% of his threes.
Well, we talked to Rick Adelman before the game. He said Porter probably has been the most unselfish he's been all season long, giving himself up to try to make his team successful through all the injuries.
Barkley trying to maneuver inside. He is fouled. Let's look at Barkley. See the spot he likes to post up in inside, and this time against Buck Williams.
Well, you see he's going quickly with it. Normally, Charles likes to hold it and see where the defensive double teams are coming from. Here he goes quickly to the shot. The next time down the floor after these two makes, Portland went to a quick double team, and Charles picked up the foul.
Buck Williams picked up a foul a minute ago, and they inbounds again, and we have a foul coming up this time. It's against Porter. Two quick fouls against the Blazers.
Here's the screen roll, a deadly combination. Barkley and Kevin Johnson on the screen roll. They'll have to trap this and try to rotate quickly.
Marley saves it out front. Has to change his shot as an end result misses it. Tries to foul. Look at his hustle, would you? Turn around, a three on the way, and that is just tenacity on the part of Dan Marley.
Well, Marley was too close to the basket. He had about a 10-footer. Double pumped it, found it, and went right to the three-point line in the corner. That's two quick threes for Marley in the ballgame.
Well, was it Paul Westphal said, I never want to take him out of the lineup. Mark Bryant backing in, misses an easy one. They missed some easy shots inside in the early going.
I think he was surprised he was so wide open. Barkley didn't even challenge the shot.
Good catch by West, but out of control. Porter with the board. The Suns are back. Porter takes it to the hole, partially blocked. It'll be goaltending. Barkley got a piece of it. but it'll be goaltending against Phoenix.
The one thing I notice about Charles Barkley right now, he has very live legs. He's been out for a while. He's had a chance to rest. The question will be conditioning. He has not had an opportunity to play many minutes. I think they'd like to get him about 30, 32 minutes tonight if possible.
Porter has all seven of Portland's points. They trail 12-7, 8 minutes to go, first quarter. Barkley ducks in, split the defenders, laid it up and in. He said he had a little fatigue in the shoulder, not a lot of pain there after the sprained right shoulder.
Well, you can see, Gary, he's thinking score at this point in time. That's three quick baskets. That time he shows a little head and shoulder fake. Watch this now, up and under. He shows the shot. Buck Williams raises up. Jerome Kersey comes over, and Charles just splits the double team. So just tremendous one-on-one basketball by Charles Barkley. Two quick jump shots, and he takes the ball to the basket off the little head and shoulder fake.
See, the Blazers struggling. 3 of 9, the Suns 6 of 9. That foul was against Mark West, trying to fight through the screen just a moment ago. And it goes to Buck Williams. The veteran spins. Nice running hook by Buck Williams.
What did Rick Adelman tell us before the game? He said about the last 10 days to 2 weeks, you could see Buck Williams playing much better ball.
And how about this move by Mark West? West with a power dunk.
See, I think they're going to need him for the playoffs. He's going to have to give them a threat inside.
Kersey out of control, but he is fouled as he ducks inside, hits the deck. Kersey's been hurt a lot this year. He's had tendonitis in a knee a couple of times with sore ribs, but back. And as Rick Adelman tells, they really feed off of his emotion.
Jerome Kersey is a player that excites this crowd. He plays so hard. This is the kind of plays he makes, the slashing, dashing drive to the basket. And Kersey has been playing with some very sore ribs. He got some pleurisy in the ribs. Then he got a touching pneumonia. They finally had to sit him down. And I sort of think he's the emotional guy of this team. He makes the tough plays. Rick Adelman was talking about the game the other night. It was a very close game against San Antonio. He just ripped the ball away from David Robinson late, scored on a layup, and got fouled, and really made the critical play for them to be able to beat San Antonio in a very important game the other night for home court positioning.
Mark West comes out after committing his second foul. Tom Chambers checks in. 7:12 to go in quarter number one. Trying to shake loose inside. Kevin backs away from Rod Strickland. Rebound by Kersey. Kersey does a good job of getting their break started. Kicks it out quickly. Williams finishes. The veteran Buck Williams, he's been in the playoffs. You mentioned he's stepping up his game as they come down the stretch of this regular season. Baseline Sabonis, a nice reverse.
I think he's the best in the league on the baseline. He hides back there, you don't see him, and he's has these snake-like moves around the basket. He finishes nicely with his left and right hand. Sensational play by Sabonis.
18-13. Passed inside, and a foul coming up against Tom Chambers of the Suns. We're going to take a break. 6:32 to go, first quarter. The Suns 18-13.
A chemical spill threatens the town of Jasper Lake, and the townspeople are dying to find out who's behind it. It's up to Sheriff Abel Marsh to find the truth. Andy Griffith stars in Deadly Game, Friday, 10:30 on TNT.
The baseball season hits full stride,
and everybody's gunning for Atlanta.
So it's up to the Braves bats to battle back.
Come on, Braves!
The Braves take on the Cardinals. Three games live beginning at 8:30 Eastern Friday night on TBS.
Every game has its critical moments. So does every life. There's a critical moment for you this prom and graduation season. But it's not when you decide to go to the prom, and it's not when you accept your high school diploma. It's when you and your friends agree to celebrate without alcohol.
Make the smart move this prom and graduation season.
Leave alcohol out. If I make a bad move, I miss a basket. If you make a bad move, you can miss the rest of your life.
Some mountains are over 500 million years old. And while water still covers over two-thirds of them,
Doug, we were just talking while we were away. What a difference this team looks like, the Portland Trailblazers, when they were Rod Strickland are there opposed to Clyde Drexler. He already has three assists in this ballgame.
Rod Strickland makes this team run. If they will rebound the ball, the rebounding is down, their scoring is down, but if they will rebound the ball and kick it out to him, Porter can run the floor as a scorer, spot up at the three-point line, shoot the ball. They get Drexler back, he can run the lane to finish. Now they love to run a four-man break with that fourth guy down the floor. Can be a Buck Williams, a Kersey, or a Cliff Robinson coming right in with their great speed. And that's when Portland is a great team. So if they can get Drexler back, the addition, I think, of Strickland and LA will really show in the playoffs and will show their depth and versatility, something we have not seen in the regular season.
Boy, guy's really been unselfish to spin this guy, Porter. He's moved back and forth from the shooting guard to the point guard. A nice running one-hander. He's 4-4 from the field now.
Well, now he's taking the ball to the basket. You must honor his three-point shot. He's made two nice drives, that time a left-hander over the top of a leaping Charles Barkley.
Barkley trying to get away from Buck Williams. The last time they played here, Barkley had a quiet 20 points. He was 0 for 5 from three-point land. Buck Williams did a very commendable job against him. Tom Chambers gets it off to Barkley. 4 seconds on the shot clock. Rebound Sabava. So active, as you mentioned, so effective on the baseline. He has 4 rebounds as to get it back outside.
See, Chambers gives them a different look in there than Mark West. If they're going to double team, Chambers will spot up and make the open shot. So look for him to find an open area and shoot some jump shots.
Kicks it out to Barkley, to Marley, who started the game with a three. He's got another one.
That's three now for three for Dan Marley from three-point range. So he's off to an excellent start. His only miss is a little 10-foot leaner in the lane.
They were 1 of 11 from three-point land against Houston on Monday night. There's a left-hander by Rod Strickland.
It's a great matchup. Kevin Johnson, Rod Strickland, two sensational
and Chambers. How about this for a finishing move? Chambers was out 9 games with a torn muscle in his thigh. He came back, seemed to be refreshed during that break, and has played very hard, and Strickland answers at the other end. Sabavis, well, they're going to match baskets, it looks like. This time, Buck Williams comes down with it. Tempo will pick it up a little bit here. Porter trying to duck in on Marley.
Nice defense that time by Marley to shut off the drive.
Marley is the soul of this team, plays so tough, hard all the time. Porter takes it to the hole, and Porter is off to a sensational start. He cuts the Suns' lead to 2. He is 5 of 5 from the field.
Now, what happens when Mark West goes out? You don't have Oliver Miller in the game. You become a small team, a short team, no shot blocking. Porter recognizes that. He's taking the ball right to the basket.
And a reach around by Porter. Marley then rejects it back to Sabalas. Heads up play by Dan Marley defensively.
Yeah, because they had a breakaway. It looked like Porter was sneaking out ahead of the field, and Marley got his hands up nicely. That's why you always try to instruct the defensive players, get your hands up, get the ball, get your hands in the passing lane, maybe get a deflection, and that's what Marley did. He got his team 2 points.
He's averaging over 39 minutes a game. He has had so many games this year when he's played 40-plus minutes.
Boy, Rod Strickland really looking to take Kevin Johnson here early in the game off the dribble.
Barkley with an impressive defensive board. Pass to Marley. Nice catch. Tries to reverse it. Partially blocked, and Sabalas then somehow got it to go through.
Well, I had the game in Chicago where Sabalas had 21 points in the first half, just sneaking around. They run no plays for him. He gets out on the break. He gets on the baseline, takes advantage of the double teams.
Well, he can score on a bundle, can't he? There's Kersey slicing down the middle.
Phoenix a little soft defensively right now. They're giving up a lot of easy scores. On the season, their opponents are shooting 48%, so teams do shoot a high percentage against them.
On the blocks to Barkley, good rotation out to Kevin Johnson. Porter with the rebound. Porter tried to take Marley baseline. Look at the good defense by Dan Marley. He just shut him off. Buck Williams posting up now on Chambers. Check that, Mark Bryant. Bryant backing in. And Chambers got a piece of it, and we're going to have a jump ball. Jake O'Donnell said a jump ball. And so they'll jump it up at that end of the floor.
Gary, Mark Bryant did everything right, except watch at the last minute here. We got a great camera angle. Look where he brings this ball. He's got him beat. Look where he brings it, right down to his knee. And when he does, Chambers just reaches in and ties him up. So had he kept that ball up, he would have had a nice opportunity for an easy score, as we see Cliff Robinson, who is probably a shoe-in for the sixth man award this season.
And this guy, Mario Elias, checked in as Robinson not quite ready to play. Doesn't come up with that one. You're right, though. He's got to be the shoe-in for the sixth man of the year.
Well, he's actually been their best player all season long when you look at numbers and percentages and points scored and block shots, everything.
That'll be off of Ellie. It'll be Phoenix's basketball. And we're going to take a break with 2:54 to go in this fast-paced first quarter. 27-23, Phoenix.
This is one of the easiest places for a Jeep Cherokee to go. But not because of its proven capability or its legendary Jeep ruggedness. What makes it so easy to bring the classic Jeep Cherokee here is the price.
save an additional $500 on new 93 Jeep Cherokee.
Presenting Digital Music Express. 30 channels of CD quality music. The music you want to hear when you want to hear it. The MX comes through your TV cable into your tuner and right into your stereo. And you get all 30 channels for a lot less than you ever thought you'd pay for music. If you like music, you're going to love DMX. Digital Music Express. Just call us today.
It's here. Emporium Storewide Super Sale. 4 days of super savings on fashion. Now up to 40% off. This Thursday through Sunday, save 20% on Nike, Adidas, ASICS, Saucony, and TurnTech athletic shoes. Save 30% on the entire stock of women's denim jeans. For men, solid interlock polo shirts are only $11.99. All this and much more, like free custom gift wrapping, styles, savings. Super Sale, now only at Emporium.
This program is authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the National Basketball Association solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, reproduction, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game without the express written consent of the National Basketball Association is prohibited.
27-23, the Suns. Doug, when you move the ball, you pass it, you really start to create problems.
You sure do, and Phoenix is so much of Kevin Johnson. What he does is he brings penetration. You're going to see him set the man up. Now, as he gets inside, if we stop it right there, you see all the defense pulled. Now you've got guys scrambling. All right, they make a mistake here. They run at Barkley, and they leave Marley. You have got to let Barkley take the shot and stay with Marley. So that's identification of shooters on the perimeter. You can't run at a non-shooter. Now, Barkley will fire him up there. But on the season, he's a 30% three-point shooter. He's made 65 of them. Marley is at 37%. He's made 155. So he's second in the league in three-point makes behind Reggie Miller. Danny Ainge is third with 148. So you can see that they use the weapon, the three-point shot. They've taken 1,063 threes as of tonight.
They've hit 381 coming in here. They had three to that, all of them by Marley. Here's Barkley turn around, and he hits the shot dead center. You know, I'm always curious, Doug, when you're on the injured list, you come back, how your shooting touch is affected.
Well, some guys more than others. Charles is shooting the ball very well tonight. You see Buck Williams with the inside play. I always struggled coming back because so much of my game was running, and then you get a little tired and your shooting falters on you. But Charles looks to be very fresh tonight. His legs are sharp and his shooting touch is very good.
And he is getting focused.
There's that three I was talking
about. This
will
be the three from the corner now. As I said, he did not hit a three in the last game they played here. He's 0-for-2 tonight. Marley will take it inside. This is what makes him so tough. You got to respect him as a three-point shooter, and then he'll thunder to the basket.
What it does is it makes you half a step quicker than you normally are because someone's running at you, and what you have to do, you have to run at a guy's right hand. They did the job, but he put it on the floor with his left and finished. No one stepped up to play against him at the basket.
The veteran, Buck Williams, a little junk hook. This guy has such an immense presence in the locker room. A real leader on this ball club. At 33 years of age, he has 8 points. He's 4 of 5 from the field.
You know, on the season, he's averaging 6 shots a game. He already has 5. They really have not utilized Buck Williams this year in their offense.
Williams cut that baseline spin move down, didn't he? He'll take it away from you. Marley reloads it inside to Barkley.
See, now Ellie can't leave or Marley's going to get the shot, so they have to come to Robinson, and now they find Kevin Johnson. That's what you want to do. You want to make Kevin Johnson be your shooter.
They have the shot clock all messed up at this end. It's really hard to tell, and the players weren't sure how much time was left on the shot clock as Cliff Robinson can't get it, and Barkley has a rebound. The one to the right is working, but the one as we move to the left now has been malfunctioning. Jake O'Donnell came over to indicate that to us, and obviously as you watch it, you cannot figure out what the number is. 57 seconds left in the quarter. Barkley backing in on Robinson. Nice touch.
Well, Charles has played a sensational first quarter.
You'd never know he'd been out of there, would you?
No, he's shooting the ball very well. But the thing I like is he's got a nice rhythm in his game. He's playing with very good patience, taking his time, and just taking what the defense gives him.
Art Bryant is fouled by Kevin Johnson. We have 40.3 seconds left in the first quarter. This is the final home game of the regular season for the Portland Trail Blazers, meeting the Phoenix Suns. These two teams have captured the Pacific Division title the last 3 years. And Phoenix coming in here after losing 3 in a row, trying to end Portland's 7-game home winning streak. And it's a 33-27 game. I'm Gary Bender along with Doug Collins. Bryant hits a free throw.
the patience of Charles Barkley. He realizes the shot clock is winding down. He still knows he has plenty of time. A couple pump fakes and he fades away. Cliff Robinson, an excellent shot blocker. He has 154 shot blocks on the season. He's 10th in the league. But Charles, with a fading shot, there was nothing that Cliff Robinson could do.
One reason Mark Bryant is starting, he's so quick, he's so active. He gets him up and down the floor better than Kevin Duckworth had been the starter since mid-1988.
Yeah, but they, you know what? Rick Adelman knows they're going to need an active Duckworth. You see the foul there on Porter. But Gary, what happens is you become a very small team. Mark Bryant is oversized or undersized in there against the opposing big players. And what you do is you get manhandled against a bigger team. So he can get by right now because he's playing against the Tom Chambers. In the first round, it looks like they're going to be playing David Robinson. So that's where they need an active Kevin Duckworth to give him a big body to play against Robinson.
Porter goes out with his second foul. Strickland comes in and a baseline move by Barkley. And Barkley is just like in midseason form after being out 5 games on the injured list. He's 6 of 8 from the field.
Simplest play in basketball, the give and go, screen and roll, and Kevin Johnson does it very well. Barkley slipped it.
Illegal defense, first time, the warning now against the Phoenix Suns. And here is Clyde the Clyde, and they are 20-10 with him out of the lineup, as Ellie now will go to line.
For Miller checking in.
Hey, he doesn't weigh 300 pounds now. He's down to about 285, I think, 290.
He looks good, and the thing that surprised me about Oliver Miller is his shot blocking. He has 99 blocked shots in 53 games. Paul Westphal said he's got very long arms, so don't be surprised. Although he's only 6'9", he has the arms of a 7-footer.
Had a high of 7 after hitting a career-high 6 blocked shots before that. So we've come to the end of this first quarter of play. A 5-point lead for the Suns.
The United States Navy wants him put away. And Jack Nicholson makes sure he goes out in style. In The Last Detail, tonight on TNT.
When the final bell sounds here on Wall Street, there'll be winners and there'll be losers. We'll sort it all out for you, put it in some perspective, and figure out for whom the bell tolls.
Moneyline with Lou Dobbs, weeknights on CNN.
Something to drink, sir?
Yeah, make it a Bud Light.
Sorry, we just ran out.
Oh. Excuse me.
Bud Light?
Try Flight 261 out of L.A.
Oh, thank you.
If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Do you have a Bud Light?
Yes. Welcome aboard, sir.
Great. Where are we going?
Even if you can afford some of life's luxuries, you still need a way to get them home. Which is why the Isuzu Trooper comes with a cavernous amount of cargo space. 90.2 cubic feet, to be exact.
850, no one bid 850. Masha, sold to the gentleman in the blue blazer.
Plus, it's got a rather large towing capacity. The Isuzu Trooper, practically amazing.
Gray held a minor post in the British Secret Service. He was contacted by Dockers. Come to America, we said. We'll build a whole wardrobe around you. Gray went for it. And now from gunmetal gray and flint to granite and slate, Gray's one of our best agents. It's all very hush-hush, of course, but the truth's bound to leak out. Nobody does Gray like Dockers.
Multnomah Falls kind of looks like your backyard.
Yeah.
Back in Chicago.
That's how much rain we've had, so it's coming off the house.
How about this first quarter? Suns didn't have any turnovers. Porter missed nothing from the field. He was 5-5 at 11 points. Sabonis, Barkley, Marley at 31 points, and KJ with 9 assists.
Well played first quarter. I don't think that either team has settled in defensively right now. Let's see if the game goes on. We get a little bit of defensive presence out there. Right now, both teams are doing whatever they want on the offensive end of the floor.
You saw the shooting statistics, 60-61. Cliff Robinson, he's forced a couple now. Inside, little Rod Strickland, and he is fouled. Good hustle. Richard Dumas, who has just checked into the ballgame, reaching in there. The Dumas of the ballgame. Oliver Miller, who came in just before the end of the quarter. Ainge is in the ballgame, along with Tom Chambers and Kevin Johnson.
When you start seeing, excuse me, Gary, you start seeing the depth of these teams now. You've got KJ as the starting point guard, and now you've got four reserves in there with him. So Phoenix has already gone nine deep. And you look at Portland, they've come in with Cliff Robinson, Mario Elie, and Kevin Duckworth. So they've played eight guys. You had Drexler, so they're nine deep, really, when you talk about their playoff roster. So,
well, Rick Adelman feels the Suns have the deepest bench in the NBA. Now, there is Strickland missing a free throw, changing the shot, gets the basket, and he's fouled by Oliver Miller.
If we can watch Rod Strickland, though, he's really struggled in the last month at the free throw line. He is very uncomfortable shooting the free throw. This, watch him as he follows the free throw. He's already going after it. He knows he's missed it. Let's watch him in this possession to see if he shoots it with a little more confidence. He has not been very good at the free throw. And look, he wants to chase it down again. So his thoughts are with the miss rather than the feeling I'm going to make this free throw. Free throw shooting, very much repetition and confidence.
37-35, the Suns by two as we start this second quarter play. Oliver Miller out to Ainge. Ainge looked like he might have had a shot, tried to dump it inside to Chambers. That's the first turnover against the Suns in this game. Kersey out of control. Ainge with the rebound. Danny Ainge playing the heavily taped right wrist, which has really affected his shooting. Be interested to see if he can get it back. Oliver Miller wide open. Boy, this guy can be big in the playoffs.
He's got a shooting touch, and it'll be interesting to see how he handles the pressure of the playoffs. Just a young man who, I think, over the last month has really made Phoenix a serious championship contender. I know that sounds crazy, Gary, but with he and Mark West, they've given the size they need to compete against the longer, bigger teams in the NBA.
You're going to run into some of those teams, especially if you meet a team like the Houston Rockets, who just dominated them on the boards Monday night. Oliver, quick turnaround jumper. Duckworth can't hang on. Dumas dumps it off to Ainge. Ainge from the corner.
Well, when you're struggling, you love those little jump shots. Yeah. I'm sure Danny Ainge breathes a sigh of relief as that shot goes in the basket. He has not shot the ball well. Has really struggled, really, since the All-Star break from three-point line.
He was shooting 47% in the first 48 games. Now down to 32 in the last 29. Here's Cliff Robinson changing his shot. Kevin Duckworth has it taken away by Ainge. Duckworth having a tough time hanging on to the ball.
Kevin Duckworth is a frustrated player right now.
Yeah, I think not starting has affected his play as Chambers can't get it, and Dumas then hits the deck as he and Kersey were tangled up. It'll be a foul on Jerome Kersey.
Danny Ainge is going to get the little open shot. Now, this is one of the toughest shots to make in the game. Little in-between shot, and Danny did a good job. He shot the ball. He did not try to steer it. 20-second timeout now by the Phoenix Suns. But I watched Kevin Duckworth on the last possession, and the shot went up, and he stopped between the midcourt line and the free throw line. Never made it all the way back down the floor. And I think the one thing that Rick Adelman wants to see him is activity, playing hard. Last ball game, he got three fouls in the first 4 minutes he played, never came back into the game. And they need Kevin Duckworth. When he played very, very well, they were a team that challenged for the NBA title.
You know, it's interesting, Doug, you see guys who are demoted as starters who do not stay in the starting lineup and how they really take it personally, how it affects their overall play. Well, Kevin is a very sensitive guy.
They become their own worst enemies, and then what happens is that they start playing poorly, then the fans get down on, then it's a vicious cycle, then you can't do anything right. So Kevin Duckworth needs to play aggressively, make the play when it's there, but the big thing is be active.
And we're going to have a loose ball foul on Oliver Miller, pushing off that time. That's his second. He and Elie were going for the ball. There's a case again of the big guy putting the ball down on the floor and getting in trouble.
I think Oliver has a tendency, I've watched him, to get a little careless with the basketball. He gets lazy. He's going to realize how quick these guys are with their hands in the NBA. You expose the ball, they're going to knock the ball away from you.
Well, I tell you, Miller and Duckworth really going after each other inside. Strickland takes it inside, changes his shot.
Strickland is penetrating at will. He's going to the basket whenever he wants to. You've seen that neither coach has taken their point guard out, so see which one blinks first. I think whenever one of them goes out, you're going to see the other take their point guard out, because they're going to have those guys against each other as the night goes on.
9 points for Strickland. Now, Oliver Miller's hit two open shots like that. That's got to help his confidence. Strickland trying to penetrate. Duckworth gets it.
No question. Anytime you can make a couple open jump shots, it's going to help you. It's going to raise the level of your play. You're going to rebound better and defend better.
Miguel Knight is getting ready to come in, so it looks like the Suns will blink first at that point guard spot. Here is Elie. What was that? He had a shot. He gets it off to Kersey, and he's stripped by Dumas.
Well, Robinson
had a layup.
Robinson ran to the corner instead of finishing up behind him. Now, there's the open shot for Ainge, the open 15-footer. That's a four-point swing.
Wow.
Elie should have taken the ball right to the basket. Robinson went to the corner instead of running the lane, and I think he surprised Mario Elie.
I guess, surprising. 45-41. The Suns backing in as Kersey. Kersey, some big bodies colliding. No foul. Tries to follow. Chambers is looking for trouble. He wanted to have a foul. No damage, I guess. The Suns have the ball. Dumas trying to create inside. And still no whistle as Dumas takes it to the hole.
This Phoenix team is so strong on the offensive end. Look at the guys that they have coming off the bench. Ainge, Dumas, Chambers, Miller. Every one of these guys can score. So when Paul Westphal rests people, he doesn't have to worry if he's going to have a drought out there offensively. The only thing he has to worry about is his defensive presence.
They double down on Duckworth. That pays off. Ainge has it stripped momentarily by Robinson. Sets it out to Kevin, and he'll wait for his troops to get down there. Chambers to the cutting Dumas. He's such a good slasher, and he's fouled. That's what he does best, Doug, is slashing to the basket.
Very similar to Sabalas, except he's a better shooter. He's still a little tentative. We talked to Westphal before the game because of his ankle. He says he's still not where he wants to be. But this young man has an all-star future ahead of him. They feel very strongly, so strongly, that they would not make the Dennis Rodman deal involving Richard Dumas. So that's why Dennis Rodman is not with the Phoenix Suns. They were not going to give up this young man.
We'll have another coming. We want to invite you to join TNT Sports Sunday Night for the 1993 NBA playoff preview beginning at 8 o'clock. Ernie Johnson will be in our Atlanta studios with my buddy here, Doug Collins, and Hubie Brown to break down all the playoff matchups as they begin right here on TNT a week from tonight.
Well, I'm looking forward to the show. It should be very, I think, informative, give people a chance to look at the playoff picture. And then I'm really excited about the playoffs this year because I think it's the first time in a long time that there's a lot of teams that can win it.
Strickland, who has been just sensational, 11 points for Rod, 47-43 the Suns. Here's Miguel Knight, a collision and a foul on Danny. Make that Tom Chambers as he and Strickland got tangled up. That'll be the third foul, I guess, on Chambers. Let's check it out. It is his third.
Sabalas back in the game for Dumas. Now, I'm a little surprised that Rick Adelman has not taken Rod Strickland out of the game to give him a little rest and maybe come back with Terry Porter while Kevin Johnson is sitting down. I thought that he would like to keep them matched up, those two guys, as the game goes on. We'll have to see if Porter comes back soon.
Kelly is going to have to play a lot more the point guard through the course of this game because of their depth problems. Kevin Duckworth, turnaround jumper. He just doesn't look confident at all. Miller with a defensive board. Two on one, three on one. Sabalas may have overpassed it there. Ellie comes up with a steal.
Well, we talked about no turnovers. Now turnovers becoming a factor in this game. Phoenix has given up a couple transition breaks with turnovers, as has Portland. So the game now starting to get a little bit more of a defensive posture. Guys making some contesting plays rather than give up easy scores.
A foul against the Suns. There's a break in the action.
Automobile Magazine said, it's more spacious and luxurious than a Jeep Grand Cherokee. The Isuzu Trooper. Practically amazing. There are those that think the Isuzu Trooper is the best-looking four-wheel drive on the road today. We happen to think it also looks pretty attractive on paper, too. Presenting the Trooper Lease. See your Isuzu dealer for details.
Emporium Storewide Super Sale. 4 days of super savings on fashion. Now up to 40% off. This Thursday through Sunday, save 20% on Nike, Adidas, ASICS, Saucony, and Turntech athletic shoes. Save 30% on the entire stock of women's denim jeans. For men, solid interlock polo shirts are only $11.99. All this and much more, like free custom gift wrapping, styles, savings. Super Sale, now only at Emporium.
Welcome to your world. Seems like everything is self-serve these days. If you want something done right, you've got to do it yourself, right? Not always. In a self-service world, it's nice to know someone out there still knows the value of full service. Full service in a self-serve world. TCI.
Down the stretch and the playoffs just around the corner. Let's look now at the matchup. If we started playing the games tonight, the Suns, of course, going against the Lakers that they've beaten five times, and then they would play if they moved on to meet the Blazers and the Spurs.
I think that's why this is a pride game, because it looks like the Suns should beat the Lakers, and if the Blazers play well, they would have to be favored against the Spurs if we play in the second round. And Phoenix has not yet won in this building. The four games have all been won by the home teams. Phoenix would like to break through tonight. Now, you say, well, there's no Drexler. It doesn't matter. You've got to win in another team's building just to get that feeling. That's why I think it was important that Houston and Seattle went in and won late in the season at Phoenix. Now they have won in Phoenix.
You know, Phoenix is 6-8 on the road against Pacific Division teams, and of course 0-2 here. Miguel Knight, who picked up that foul just before the break, off to Chambers, rebound Duckworth. Rod Strickland, who has gotten this team started so effectively, dumps it off. Percy can't control it off of the Suns. 18 seconds on the shot clock. One thing about Portland, they've had a tough time rebounding and getting their running game going, but they got it out then.
Well, they were one of the better rebounding teams in the league, either one or two last year. They have slipped this year, and as a result, their points per game are down, their field goal percentage is down on the season, and it's really forced them to be more of a half-court team.
What a block by Kersey. Help defense, and it paid off, and he gets the ball back at the other end. That was a baseline-to-baseline maneuver by Jerome Kersey.
That's what Jerome Kersey brings, a spectacular block, and now the finish on the other end, and now you've got the crowd into the game.
And we're tied at 47. Chambers with a leaning one-hander gets it.
Tom Chambers, this guy can really score.
Tom Chambers has really changed his game this year to welcome Charles Barkley. He wants that championship ring, as Strickland now is fouled. Let's go back to the Jerome Kersey show.
The spectacular play, he's off the ball, he's coming to block the shot, he gets his running start, he times it perfectly, and now he does not quit on the play. Look at him in the right lane. Strickland's gonna reward him for the great block and also for running the floor. That's what your point guard is supposed to do, take advantage of the opportunity to reward the guy for making the great play.
15 foul against the Suns as Miguel Knight picked up his second. At the conclusion of tonight's game, Doug and I will be selecting the Budweiser player of the game.
Let's keep our camera on Rod Strickland, and let's watch as he shoots this free throw as he falls forward.
He's 1 of 4 thus far, Doug, now 1 of 5, and he gets his own shot back again. Second time he's done that. Gets it off now to Robinson. Ellie! What a follow!
What a tip in by Mario Ellie!
We're tied at 49. Miguel Knight off to Chambers. Wide open shot, and he buries it.
Well, you better not blink against Phoenix, because they're coming right back. They're going to retaliate. They're going to run back at you off makes or misses. So your transition defense, you must get the people. It's a tough matchup now. Duckworth has not been able to get to Chambers, so he's been able to step out on the floor and make some of his open jump shots.
20-second timeout now for the Blazers with 5:23 to go. Let's go back to Mario Ellie. Coming over everybody with this follow.
Tough shot by Robinson, but look at Ellie. No one blocking him out. He just slices through and with the left hand makes the great tip. Oliver Miller comes over to get the altered shot, and here comes Mario Ellie with his great ability to hang in the air and a nice little offensive tip in.
He is fearless going to the basket.
Yeah, well, you know, a lot of these guys, you're talking about a 6'5", 6'6", rangy athlete that finishes well and a very good free throw shooter, and a guy that when his strength is taking the ball to the basket, he can step out and make the open three, but he's more confident going and driving and taking it to the hoop.
9-2 for the Blazers as they go down the stretch drive. You can see what they've been able to do.
But look how much of it is predicated by the rebounding. They're +7 rebounding during that period of time. When they rebound, they're a very potent offensive team.
Robinson kicks it out to Ellie. He can hit the three. He's deadly.
That's what I talked about. He loves to go to the basket, but he will spot up and shoot the three. On the season, that's his 43rd three-point field goal. He's shooting about 35%.
That's a pretty good combination. It go to the basket like he does and square up outside. Miller, who's hit two from that area, has got three in a row. And Charles Barkley, in all that discussion we had last night, feels that Oliver Miller could be a big, big factor. You could see him just getting better each game. Into Ellie, backing down on Danny Ainge, kicks it off to Robinson, slicing. Changes the shot. Duckworth with a follow to put back. That might give him some confidence. He's really been struggling.
I'd like to see him smile a little bit. I really would. I think that when Kevin smiles, he's a better player. I know that sounds a little silly, but when guys frown, it looks like they're upset all the time. And I think that with Kevin Duckworth, he needs to, that smile will bring him some energy.
Well, he's not going to smile now as he's guilty of a foul there. A nice baseline move by Sabalas, a chance for a three-point play.
See, now watch Kevin's reaction now. He's going to make this nice hustle play, and he lays it in, and he just sort of runs down the floor. I'd like to see him, maybe one of his teammates run over, high-five him, slap him, let him know, great play. The problem with that is Phoenix is coming back at you, and they're going to retaliate, and they're going to score quickly, so you must get back.
Well, again, Duckworth's a very affable guy, but he's very sensitive, and he's had some moments where he gets down on himself. Here's Sabalas, who leads the NBA in field goal percentage. He's trying to take it all the way. Doesn't get it. He was off balance as Porter's checked back into the ballgame.
Giving Rod Strickland some rest, so now he's playing point guard.
Three. How about that? Just come off the bench and bury one from out there.
Well, Terry Porter on the season now. That is his 141st three-point field goal.
Porter with 14 points in the game, a two-point lead now for the Blazers, a three by Ainge. Danny Ainge still struggling from three-point land. Miller tries to save it, it'll be Portland's basketball.
And we talk about three-point shooters. Terry Porter is one of six guys in the NBA to have 600 career three-point field goals made. So
isn't that amazing? You think about it, 615.
It's a pretty select company, too, when you start looking at the other guys.
57-55. Charles Barkley's come back into the ballgame now for the Suns. Bryant is in for the Blazers. Robinson backing in on Sabalas. Ball away, and we've got a foul on Oliver Miller. Miller slicing, trying to come across from the backside. That's his third. That's a big game for Detroit. They lose that to Chicago, then forget the playoffs.
That's also a big game for Chicago. If they lose that to Detroit, then it probably limits their hopes of being able to have an opportunity to get the home court from New York on Sunday afternoon, so Chicago must win their remaining ball games.
Mark West now will come back into the ball game for Phoenix as Robinson will get another free throw. A 3-point lead now for Portland.
Clip has gotten off to a little bit of a slow start here in this ball game. It looks like he's been trying to draw some fouls on his shot. He's 1-for-6 here. He's doing a lot of leaning, trying to create contact. They have not given him that call other than the last time down the floor. He needs to just go right up and take the shot.
Well, the Blazers are getting some calls, though. They have 16 free throws to the Suns' 3. Miguel Knight from outside. Rebound ripped down by Puck Williams. They got the Suns in trouble on Monday night. They started shooting the perimeter shots, the outcourt shot. Porter, he felt that and was going the minute he let it go. He has that feel right now, as they say, the shooters will come up with.
Well, he had Miguel Knight on his heels. Miguel Knight was backpedaling, and Porter went right to the three-point line. He had just done it the previous play. He was going to pull up and do it once again.
That was his first miss, Doug, of the night. He is 6-of-7 shooting tonight. Mark West with a power move.
Great give and go. Danny Ainge. Mark West. I really believe that Mark West is going to be an important part, too. I think he's going to have to score a few points just to keep the defense honest inside.
At top of Valley, it'll be Phoenix's basketball. Mark West, the guy they call Big Daddy. And Big Daddy has acquitted himself well in this first half. Timeout. Portland by 2.
The NBA on TNT is brought to you by Isuzu, makers of incredible four-wheel drives, and by Levi's Dockers. Nobody does color like Dockers.
Hey, guys, I got more basketball cards.
Well, open them up. Hey,
okay.
Potter, the killer cross over. He gets it.
I'm home.
Hey, Dad, I got Jordan in the pack you got me, and I also got...
Over here. Kill
David Robinson averaged 24 points as a rookie.
So what, Larry Johnson averaged 11 boards.
Hello?
Hi, Lisa?
Hi, Billy.
Hey, look, we got Patrick Ewing.
All right!
NBA basketball cards bring the action home.
Even if you can afford some of life's luxuries, you still need a way to get them home. Which is why the Isuzu Trooper comes with a cavernous amount of cargo space. 90.2 cubic feet, to be exact.
850, unknown bid 850. Sold to the gentleman in the blue blazer.
Plus, it's got a rather large towing capacity. The Isuzu Trooper. Practically amazing.
Brown. Got a phone call from Dockers. Saw you in a pair of wingtips, we said. You've got real potential. Flattered Brown threw in with us. And look at him now. saddle brown to chestnut, dark chocolate to sable, brown never looked better. It's true what they say. Nobody does brown like Dockers.
Suns led by five after one quarter, now down by two. And, Doug, I sense a little playoff atmosphere here, don't you?
You have that competitive feeling tonight of two teams who know that they could see each other once again in the playoffs. And I think it's very important for Portland tonight to try to win this game without Clyde Drexler, just to send Phoenix a message like, hey, this is our home court. You're not going to beat us, even if our best player is not here. Phoenix needs to break through. They are playing better basketball. They have not played well over the last five games. Charles Barkley had a nice rest, and during that period of time, he was out over 8 minutes. Although Portland took the lead, it's still just a two-point game.
Barkley played very effectively, 11 points in the early part of the game. Sabonis turnaround won't go. You saw a lot of white shirts on the defensive board as Strickland brings it down. Jumping out is Barkley at the switch, a mismatch inside. Bryant can't get it. Mark West with the rebound. Miguel Knight, who started the games when Kevin Johnson's been out, a three by Danny Ainge. And again, he's just not quite in that groove you expect for him. Out it comes to Barkley.
Danny looks like he is, as soon as he's releasing his shot, that he has that same feeling Rod Strickland does at a free throw, but he's not going to go in, and he's going to try to chase it down.
Yeah, he's 0 for 3 now. He's backing as Barkley traveled to the ball. Mark Bryant's hanging in there tough. They want Barkley for technicals. He slams the ball down, but nothing doing.
You know what happened? Mark Bryant backed away from him. Barkley thought he was there, and he was going to bump into him. Watch out. And there was nobody to bump into, so he walked. That's a nice play by Mark Bryant to get away from him, give him nobody to feel, and he stepped right back into a travel.
Robinson over Sabonis. Now, he's got a lot of height, 6'10 against 6'6. That's a real mismatch, that deep.
Well, they're going to have to make a decision now. You've got Sabonis and Robinson. Robinson will post him. Will they now have to go back and double-team Robinson to get the ball out of his hand?
Nice pass, Barkley to West. He'll get it. He is fouled by Robinson, a chance for a three-point play. With Doug Collins, I'm Gary Bender from the Memorial Coliseum, sold out once again. The two teams who have won the Pacific Division the last 3 years tangling, a minute 12 to go in the first half after the Suns led by five after the first quarter, now trailing 61-59 as West, not a good free throw shooter, goes to the line. He's shooting 52%. Barkley comes running in, anticipating the miss, but couldn't come up with a rebound.
That's the old Michael Jordan move in Chicago. No one getting in front of Barkley. He realizes West not a good free throw shooter, so he's going to try to make the spectacular play. It did not happen for him on that possession.
Bryant, nice fake. Takes it inside, but he stepped on the baseline. So coming up at halftime, our Reebok halftime report, Dick Versace and Ernie Johnson will have scores and highlights of tonight's games, including the Pistons in Chicago, and a breakdown of the playoff picture as it's starting to crystallize throughout the NBA. Jerrad Mustaf now coming to the ball game. He started the last two ball games for Phoenix while Barkley has been out of there.
Looks like Paul Westphal is trying to get his entire team into the game in the first half, give everybody at least a minute or so.
Nice pass by Miguel Knight. Good eye contact from Knight to Charles Barkley. Ainge pick it up on Porter. 61 all, we got a foul on Miguel Knight as he gets him from the backside. Let's go back to that play from Miguel Knight to Mr. Barkley.
Well, what happens is, in many instances, Charles is getting everybody out in isolation. He loves to come over and set a screen. And this time he just releases, goes to the back door. Buck Williams does not get his body on him, and the nice play by Miguel Knight. So from that position, Phoenix loves to walk Charles over and run screen roll with three guys in isolation. Charles with a quick reverse to the basket, and Miguel Knight with a nice play, just a little alley-oop, and Charles with a nice finish.
14 points for Barkley. Porter, very good free throw shooter, shooting 85%. He leads his team in minutes played. As we mentioned earlier, he's had to play both the point, the off guard, has been totally unselfish. One of those guys who has not been slowed by injury this year.
Let's see if Phoenix tries to get a quick shot up here in about 5 or 6 seconds to go 2-for-1.
Inside 30 seconds to go. Barkley with a three. He's 0 for 3 from that area. And Strickland reaching out on Ainge, but he can't control it. It'll be Phoenix's basketball.
It's a 2-for-1 possession. Barkley took the three. You wonder why he launched it so deeply, but he was trying to get the extra possession, and that will happen now. There's a 21 seconds on the Shot clock, 22 seconds on the game clock, so a little over a 1 second differential.
West comes out of the ball game. Dumas comes in with 22 seconds left in the half. Mustaf looking at Knight, wants to know what they've got on here. 13 seconds. Suns going for the tie here. Knight kicks it in. Dumas can't control it, and instead, Buck Williams has got it. To Porter, that will not count if it goes. Wave it off. He got it off after the buzzer had sounded. So Portland has a 2-point lead at halftime, 63-61. Barkley with 14 points, 3 rebounds in this first half. 16 for Porter. Strickland with 11 points in the ball game. And so you sense the playoffs are just around the corner. These two old rivals going after each other. Ernie Johnson coming up in Atlanta.
One of these engines was filled with Castrol Syntec, a synthetic oil, the rest with conventional oils. They were then drained and started without oil to prove a point. You see, Syntec has a unique molecular structure that bonds to engine parts. Lab tests show it leaves a layer of protection far stronger than conventional oil. And if Syntec protects this well now, imagine if you leave it in. Castrol Syntec protects in ways other oils can't.
What's the difference between these two sandwiches? This one's free. Or is it this one?
I love this place!
Well, did you know that if you buy one Gris sandwich, you get the second one free?
Well, I was wondering where it came from.
Buy one, get one free.
I love this place.
Buy one, get one free. That's free, as in zip, zero, zilch, nada, goose egg, free!
I love this place!
Right now at Burger King, buy a double cheeseburger and get the second one free.
Buy one, get one free.
I love this place.
Welcome to the 1993 Reebok Black Top Burger Fest! D.C., Philly, Brooklyn, Atlanta, Chi-Town, we're in the house! Look out, y'all, it's Bill Shorty Rock! Yo, check it out! That's what I'm talking about! This is Black Top! You come strong, or you don't come at all! I'll go!
Reebok Halftime Report is brought to you by Reebok. To remind you that on Planet Reebok, there are no rules.
All right, and one of those typical high-scoring Western Conference things, Portland 63, Phoenix 61 at the break. Ernie Johnson in Atlanta with the Reebok Halftime Report, joined tonight by Dick Versace. And if you missed our pregame segment, we talked about Magic Johnson, the story out of KMPC Radio in Los Angeles, that Lakers owner Jerry Buss has offered the job of head coach to Magic Johnson. Now, Jerry West, the Lakers GM, says to his knowledge, he has heard of no offer to anybody to be head coach. And I know you talked to Lon Rosen, who's Magic's agent.
Well, Lon Rosen says, hey, there's absolutely nothing to it. He says Magic had 3 coaching offers during the course of the year. What Magic really wants to do is he wants to own an NBA team.
Makes for intriguing conversation, if nothing else. Let's talk about the playoffs. They begin 1 week from tonight. Let's talk about the Eastern Conference and break it down for you. 1 through 4 right now, the great battle for the overall lead there.
Well, Ernie, New York is on a mission. Chicago is turning up the Dobermans right now. Cleveland is the hottest team in the East, but the team that everybody wants a piece of is Boston.
And when we talk about everybody, we're talking about the 5, 6, and 7 teams all gunning for the number 5 spot and the right to play Boston rather than face one of those top 3 teams, New Jersey, Atlanta, and Charlotte, all involved in that fight. And then you've got the battle for the final playoff spot in the Eastern Conference, Indiana, Orlando, and Detroit. And do the Pistons really want to get in there?
Now, my opinion is that they don't. They have a chance to get young. They're an aging team. They can get very, very young if they would take the pick that they got from Miami when they traded John Sally. And they're going to have their own pick. They'll give them 2 lottery picks. They trade Dennis Rodman for 1 or 2 young players. Joe Dumars still a great player. Isaiah got something left. Lambeer on for another year. They could be a very young team and much better by not being in the lottery.
But right now they are still in the playoff hunt and playing tonight at Chicago Stadium. The Bulls, it's a big one for them. They're trying to keep the heat on the New York Knicks for the best record overall. There you see Michael Jordan and the guys at home at Chicago Stadium. Joe Dumars will fire that 3 and connect. Michael has an answer for him.
Yeah, watch this. Michael Jordan is going to take him down between the legs. Rocking chair. Up. Yes.
Very sweet by number 23 right now. Into the second period, Chicago has a 28-24 lead. over the Detroit Pistons. And when we come back on the Reebok Halftime Report, we'll set our sights on the Western Conference.
It's two core sandwiches for the price of one. This is a stick.
I love this place.
Picker sandwich, you can get it nowhere else. Not Wendy's, not McDonald's.
Buy one, get one free. Can't beat this deal with a stick.
I love this place.
You buy one double cheeseburger, get the second one for free.
I love this place.
We got two flavor oil double cheeseburgers for the price of one. Why would you go anywhere else? You buy one, you get one free.
I love this place.
AT&T.
It's always a good time to buy a case of Pennzoil. Now is a greater time, because you can get up to $4 off on any other automotive product. Pennzoil owes you one for making them America's number one selling motor oil. So go buy a case and save up to $4 on any other automotive product. That's Pennzoil's way of saying thank you, America.
Pick up your specially marked case and get up to $4 back while supplies last.
It's never fun to eat and run, to rush and eat too fast, cause you know it's gonna catch up with you at last.
For acid indigestion or heartburn with headache, nothing's faster than Alka-Seltzer.
Get yourself some Alka-Seltzer and you'll feel better fast.
The NBA playoffs on TNT. Over 30 games, bonus games, interviews, the experts.
Nobody plays the playoffs like TNT.
Nobody.
The playoffs begin April 29th on TNT.
Blazers by a bucket at the break. As the Reebok Halftime Report continues, Ernie Johnson and Dick Versace back with you. The Western Conference, we already know who the top eight teams are. We have the playoff field intact. The only question, 5 and 6, Dick.
Well, what you have is a magic number for San Antonio. The magic number is one. If San Antonio just wins one game, they control their own destiny. But they can also get the fifth spot by having Utah lose one game.
San Antonio, if they do finish number 5, would open at Portland. The remaining schedule for Utah, they've got Golden State at home, and then they're at Minnesota. San Antonio can make it all academic tonight. 3 games to go, and if they win tonight at home against Denver, then they will have the number 5 spot. They got Phoenix and Houston left. Let's take a look at the highlights from Hemisphere Arena. Who's this guy? He's a lucky fan who won a contest and certainly looks like a player, doesn't he? Antoine Carr.
Sure.
Won't mistake him for Antoine, who throws a little jumper up there. Quick 5-point lead for San Antonio. Dale Ellis fires away from 3-point land and connects. This time he does not, but there's Sean Elliott. Kicking it back out, and Sean gets it back and drains the 3-pointer. San Antonio with a 10-point lead at that point. They scored 47 in the first quarter, the team record. They lead early in the second, 47-23. Now, the Houston Rockets have already clinched the Midwest, but Vernon Maxwell got hurt, Dick, his wrist, and he's going to miss at least 2 playoff games. Big pickup for them today to take his place.
Terry Teagle. They picked up Terry Teagle from the Benetton team. He's the guy that played with Tony Kukoc. Interesting thing. This is a team, the Houston Rockets, that really think they can win it. So what they're doing is they're making sure that they cover all contingencies. To bring Terry Teagle in right now is a terrific move. They still have Scott Brooks, too, who's played very well for him.
Teagle was lighting it up in the Italian League, averaging 23 points a night. Tonight, he's back in the Houston Rocket uniform. So where he started his career back in 1982. Hakeem Olajuwon is still the man, though. A little Matador D by Christian Laettner as Hakeem goes around him at 15 points in the first period. Chuck Person got to call this bank kid. 3-pointer goes from a bizarre angle off the glass. Back to Hakeem.
Yeah, but check this out.
Working on the kid, yeah.
See, Ernie, when he makes that move, there's no way that you can stop him. That's why he's having an MVP year.
Houston winning big, or not that big, 30-28. They're into the second period. They've won 10 straight. Minnesota has lost 10 straight. Seattle and the Clippers will tip it off a little bit later at the LA Sports Arena. And the playoffs, as we have mentioned, begin next Thursday. We are going to preview everything that's going to go on Sunday night here on TNT from 8 o'clock until 9 o'clock Eastern. I'll be joined by Doug Collins and Hubie Brown, the preview show Sunday at 8, the playoffs beginning a week from tonight. Doubleheader action on TNT.
Inside, your smooth-running engine is a torture chamber. And under these grueling conditions, only one leading motor oil in every grade meets the world's toughest requirements for viscosity breakdown. Castrol. Castrol provides maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown. So use Castrol. Why make things tougher on your engine? Castrol GTX, engineered for today's smaller cars. Now get a free 24-ounce Castrol Super Clean when you buy a case of Castrol GTX.
Tire foam protectant from Armor All. One spray, and even old tires look great. Kind of makes you wish we made car foam. Tire foam from Armor All.
It's never fun to eat and run, to rush and eat too fast, because you know it's gonna catch up with you at last.
For acid indigestion or heartburn with headache, nothing's faster than Alka-Seltzer.
Get yourself some Alka-Seltzer and you'll feel better fast.
Welcome back to the Reebok Halftime Report. We've talked about playoff teams. Let's talk about lottery teams, because some of the teams are going to be among the 11 who do not make the playoffs and get those ping pong balls. And you see in the East, you got Indiana, Detroit, and Orlando. Two of those teams are not going to make it. They'll join the lottery, and Dallas guaranteed of one of the top four picks. How about your thoughts on the lottery? I know you've been doing a little digging for Satya.
Well, what happened, Ernie, is I found that there's a letter floating around the NBA, actually not floating, actually sent to all NBA owners and NBA GMs. And it was sent by Jack McCluskey of the Minnesota Timberwolves, their GM. He does not like the existing lottery system. He doesn't think it's fair that a team can finish with the 11th worst record and still have a chance to get the best player.
But to me, that's the thrill of the lottery, that one in a million chance you're going to get it.
Yeah, but see, he's looking at it from a GM standpoint. You're looking at it from a fan standpoint. I remember when I worked with Jack McCluskey in Detroit, he always felt this way. He thought it was very unfair. So he really thinks that they should reevaluate the system, not worry so much about the maneuvering that went on before, because really that only would adjust one place or two. Now you got a team, you know, like I said, with possibly having the 11th worst record, ending up with the best player. You can't build a team unless you can build it through the draft.
I still like the way it's set up. Second half, still ahead from Portland. Phoenix down by two to the Blazers. Third period just ahead.
The Reebok Halftime Report has been brought to you by Reebok, who reminds you that on Planet Reebok, there are no limits.
Did you see the game, Brett?
We see everything. Get in here.
Please sit down. Now listen closely, Shaquille. We're only going to say this once.
If you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run.
Yours is the earth and all that's in it.
Which is more, you'll be a man, my son.
Charles Bronson.
Might is right and weakness is wrong.
Christopher Reeve.
No man has the right to decide who lives or dies.
Locked in a struggle, only one will survive. The Sequel, a TNT original motion picture. After the NBA.
NBA tomorrow on TNT. The Chicago Bulls, the Charlotte Hornets, fighting for playoff position.
Come on!
Chicago enters the Hornets' nest. Bulls versus Hornets, tomorrow at 8 on TNT.
Presenting Digital Music Express. 30 channels of CD quality music. The music you want to hear when you want to hear it. DMX comes through your TV cable into your tuner and right into your stereo. And you get all 30 channels for a lot less than you ever thought you'd pay for music. If you like music, you're going to love DMX. Digital Music Express. Just call us today.
Does pizza the right way with high-quality products that go clear to the edge and reasonable prices with no gimmicks. But we're more than just a pizza parlor. Pepe's is a place for great family atmosphere. We have sandwiches, soups, salads, pasta, ribs, and of course pizza, the way pizza was meant to be made. We invite you to come in. Pepe's Pizza, still doing it right.
63-61, Portland leading Phoenix. I'm Gary Bender along with Doug Collins. It's been a game of spurts, but Doug, one thing that jumps out is both teams shooting the ball very well.
Shooting well, getting easy scores. The real difference in the game has been at the free throw line right now, where Portland is 14 of 18 and Phoenix is 0-for-4, so they have been able to lead by being able to get inside and get to the foul line.
Well, let's look at some of those statistics. You alluded to the one about the free throw situation. There it is. There's the shooting for the game, 58 and 52.
I think it's interesting. The Suns have 29 field goals on 23 assists. KJ has 11 assists in the first half, so they are moving the ball very well, getting wide open shots. 50 field goal attempts is a lot of attempts, only four free throw attempts, though. So there you do see the assists. And again, KJ, although he was only 1-for-5, with 11 assists, his season high is 16 at Chicago earlier in the year.
That's the 10th time this year he's had 10-plus assists. Let's watch this play now by Mario Elie.
Well, see, Elie has a wide-open shot, and Cliff Robinson really gives up on the play. He thinks Ellie's going to take it, so it ends up now going back to Jerome Kersey, who gets his shot blocked, and then Danny Ainge is going to get a 15-footer on the other end. So Portland, I think, got a little bit too cute. Mario Elie could have taken the ball to the basket, either gotten fouled or maybe gotten the score, tried to be a little unselfish. Here's the give and go with Barkley. Once the guy's in isolation, am I going to set the screen? No, I'm going to reverse you. I'm going to give you a little bump. And when he does, Charles with a nice finish. Charles, 7-for-10 in the first half, had 14 points, played exceptionally well.
Yeah, he really did. You wondered if he'd been a little rusty after being on the injured list for 5 games, but Sir Charles came in and acquitted himself very well. Porter came out and hit a couple of threes. They didn't miss a three. The Blazers did in the first half. They were 3-of-3.
Well, you see, he gets you on your heels, and Porter's such an excellent shooter. Now the next time you come at him, he gives you a little head and shoulders fake and gets the ball inside. So Terry Porter with a very strong first half, 6-for-7, had 16 points. I still think that at some point in time, Gary, there's going to be a 5-minute sequence in this game where someone's going to have to make a defensive stand. They've really just sort of traded baskets with each other. Both teams shooting very well, 1-of-52%, Portland. The other 58% is the Phoenix Suns. So I think that, like all games, there comes a 5-minute, and I call it a skirmish, where one of these teams is going to take control of the game. We'll have to find out when that's going to happen.
You saw those numbers on Strickland. He has one triple-double this year. He's got a chance of having his second of the season. You know, you talk about defense, and that's what everybody talks about playoff-wise, how it steps up.
Well, you know, one of the things that I wondered today, and our stat guy Jimmy Pels helped us out, I said, when is the last time a team led the league in scoring and won the championship? And it was the 74-75 Golden State Warriors with Rick Barry. So interesting to see if Phoenix can be the next team to win the championship, being the highest scoring team in the league.
Averaging over 113 a game. Rod Strickland forcing it inside. The ball comes out. Kevin Johnson lost control. And we're going to have a held ball as Rod Strickland able to convert quickly. Everybody thought maybe Kevin should have been called for traveling. Instead, they'll jump it up.
Well, it looked like he got bumped, and when he did, he tried to draw the foul. Let's watch KJ as he comes rolling out. There's the bump right there. He loses his footing. I think he thought he was going to get the foul called. When he didn't, he just stayed down on the floor with the ball, Strickland forcing the tie-up. Now, KJ with the long arm should win this tip.
And he does, and Barkley then pushes off, throws to Marley. Marley can't handle it. And he thought he was fouled by Porter, but there's no whistle. So kind of an unusual start to the second half of play.
How about Barkley threw that ball with his left hand? That was a great pass. Marley had the catch. I thought he got a little bump in the back. Lee Jones did not see it my way, and it went off Marley's leg. So Portland now with the basketball.
And Portland still that 2-point lead into Bryant, intended for Bryant. Barkley got a hand on it. Sabalas back to Sir Charles. He'll take it to the hole. Good defense that time by Buck Williams.
Charles,
he stayed with him.
Charles going to get a technical here tonight. You watch. Just mark it down.
Mark Bryant from the corner, and he doesn't get it. He's been shooting very well, by the way, Mark Bryant has. And now we're going to have a technical on Paul Westphal.
I could feel a technical coming. I didn't know where it was going to come from, but Paul Westphal was upset. He felt on the play before Marley was fouled, and then I think he felt that Barkley was fouled here. So two plays, he felt like he did not get the call, although Buck Williams made a great play there that was not a foul.
So Porter will shoot the technical free throw. Paul hasn't had very many technicals. Getting the one here with 11:01 to go in this third quarter.
Paul might be the most laid-back NBA coach. There's a lot of sitting over there. Be interesting now as the playoffs roll around and the action gets a little faster and the pressure a little higher, whether he's going to be able to keep that seat or if he's going to prance around like this nervous guy's used to.
I noticed you never did sit down very much.
No way. I didn't need
regular season or playoffs.
That's right.
Here's Parley ducking inside, and he's fouled. Well, the Charlotte Hornets have made the playoffs for the first time ever. And a game coming up tomorrow night here on TNT. We'll have those Charlotte Hornets going against the Chicago Bulls. Bob Neal and Hubie Brown describe that action. And everybody says, the Bulls, Michael Jordan, can he carry them to a three-peat?
Well, you know, it's interesting about that game. You say, how important is that game? Well, Charlotte is in a position. They can continue to move up. They don't have to be satisfied with being number seven. How important is it to Chicago? Well, Chicago must win that game in order to make Sunday's game meaningful against New York. So Charlotte, which right now would play Chicago in the playoffs, be a nice win if they could get that Charlotte tomorrow night.
Marley misses those two, and the Suns are 0 for 6 now for the free throw line.
That's amazing.
Good free throw shooting team coming in here, shooting 76% for the year. Percy backing in on Sabatis. Nice spin move. Sabatis gets a hand on it. West retrieves it. Tough inside now. Here comes Kevin Johnson, who's 1 of 5 shooting in the first half, and that will go for him.
You can sense the intensity of the game picking up.
Yeah, and here's part of it. Barkley with the inbound steal, and he is fouled by Bryant. Heads up play by Barkley.
Well, in many instances, you know, when your head coach does get a technical, it's for a reason. I think Paul Westphal just wanted to get his team a little bit fired up defensively. They're playing very well offensively.
Barkley having a remarkable year. He's fourth in scoring, sixth in rebound. Look at the 8 straight seasons. He's averaged 20-plus points and 10-plus rebounds. He's also, what I think is amazing, his assists are so good. He's averaging over 5 assists a game.
Well, the only year that Charles did not average 20 and 10 was in his rookie season, and he, at that point in time, really was coming off the bench.
But you were playing. I would think he would have had a lot of assists with your shooting. What happened there? I can't figure that. Barkley's tied it up now at 64. Can give the Suns the lead. And, man, boy, they are really struggling. They are 1 of 8 from the line. And it goes to Kersey. Sabalas giving away some height and some weight inside. Strickland ducking in. Terry Porter from outside. Another three. That's the first one he's missed. Rebound by Barkley.
See the great hands.
Oh, and this is a steal by Kersey.
There's the plays of Kersey. Barkley made a great play to get the loose ball. And then Kersey, that's twice now we've seen him with sensational plays where he just made the defensive play and then got the score.
Took a page out of Barkley's book there, who had swiped the inbound at the other end. Sabatis slicing to the basket. Nice reverse. He's fouled. Boy, he's good at that. Bryant picking up the foul.
See, I really believe that when you double-team Phoenix so much that it enables Sabalas to slash and get to the basket. And what's the hands of Barkley right here? The ball's going out of bounds. It's bouncing. He picks it up. A little bit of a careless play here. Kersey again gets his arms up. And it's funny, Gary, when you get your hands up in the passing lane, how many good things happen rather than when you carry your hands below your elbows. I always tell my kids at the basketball camp, when you play the game with your hands above your elbows. You get a chance to get deflections rather than play with your hands down below your elbows, where the only thing you can do is if someone would throw the ball to you, maybe you can make a catch.
We're even at 66, 9.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Porter going around Marley, kicks it out to Williams. Boy, they converged inside. They shut it off. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Porter trying to get loose from Marley. Running left-hander, awkward shot, and a foul inside.
It'll be a loose ball foul on Charles Barkley. Buck Williams was inside him. Barkley realized that Buck Williams would have had the easy layup, so Charles just pushed him in the back.
That's his first foul. And so they'll take it out on the far side.
Charles has done all this tonight, and he's only had one foul. That's the first time he's touched anybody tonight.
Yeah, right. I believe that.
Uh-huh. It's the first time he got caught.
Even at 66, Strickland in midair gets it outside. Shot missing by Bryant. Mentioned Bryant has been shooting well. He's been shooting 55% in the last 34 games, but he's missed a couple of shots here in the second half. He's 0 for 5 for the game. J.J. trying to duck inside. Barkley from the corner. Nope, not going to get it off. Bryant jumps out on him. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Gets in closer. He doesn't miss those very often. Buck Williams tracks it down. A They jump out on Porter to Bryant. Bryant needs one, and he got that one. That's his first hit of the night. 0 for 5 previous to that one. 2-point lead for Portland. Timeout now called by the Phoenix Suns. 8:26 to go in the third. The Blazers and Suns from Portland.
The NBA on TNT is brought to you by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. And by Dutch Boy Paint. Year after year, Dutch Boy Paint has the look that lasts.
We're almost there.
Yeah, 3 years of digging and digging.
But soon, our first taste of freedom. Here we are. Push!
What'll it be, boys?
Two Bud Lights, please.
Sorry, fellas, but we're all out.
If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
You know, Larry, we really should carry more Bud Light.
When it's this hot, don't take chances. Only Armor All Protectant guarantees your new car's dash from cracking. There is a fountain of youth, and we guarantee it. Armor All.
Dutch Boy Paint is now on sale at Sears. Regularly priced at $17.99, Dutch Boy's Kids Room Paint is now on sale for only $12.99 a gallon at Sears.
I got an 88 Chevrolet Silverado with 304,000 miles. I drive it to work 125 miles one way to work. 304,000 miles, still rolling.
I got approximately 353,000 miles on this truck. It runs 10 or 12 hours a day, 6 days a week. It's always brought us in, you know, regardless of where we was or what we were doing.
Chevrolet, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Keep tires on it, keep gas in it, it'll go.
The Blazers have maintained their halftime two-point lead, 68-66. Doug Cummins, take us through this coaching clinic.
Well, you see right here, Porter is a great shooter, so they have to jump him. And when they do, Kevin Johnson's going to continue. Harley's going to be the guy to rotate. So as Mark Bryant goes to the corner, it's Harley's responsibility to try to get there. He is late. He can't get that far, and Mark Bryant knocks the shot in. That play, I think, really was made famous by the Detroit Pistons in the glory days of Bill Laimbeer when he was rolling out, shooting that shot, setting the screens for Isaiah Thomas, Joe Dumars, or Vinnie Johnson.
Porter, the high point man on the floor, was 17 points. By the way, Marley, you mentioned him. He scored 11 points this game, all of them back in the first quarter.
Well, remember, he had three threes in that first period, and he really is a guy that they don't look to go offense to. He just finds them floating around the perimeter.
Kevin not shooting with confidence out there. Those shots need to go when the playoffs come around. Two-point lead now for Portland, approaching 8 minutes to go in the third. Rod Strickland tries to duck in on KJ, can't get there. Percy with 7 seconds on the shot clock. Nice ad-lib effort by Rod Strickland. Acrobatic move.
Rod Strickland might be as good as any guard in the league when he goes to the basket making those circus shots. Kevin Johnson again with a very difficult shot.
Yeah, that was forcing at that time. Harris, Porter taking it to the hole. He's fouled by West and a chance for a three-point play. Another surge in this ball game. And right now, the Blazers lead it 72-66. 7 minutes, 41 seconds to go in the third. The Blazers trying to win their eighth straight game at home. The final regular season meeting between these two clubs. They led by 2.5, and now with this lead, they're biggest of the ball game.
Terry Porter did a nice job. He took the ball right into the body of Mark West. He sealed him, and then he brought the ball back with his left hand. Made a beautiful little over-the-shoulder shot. Had he shot the ball with his right hand, Mark West would have been able to block it.
That was the third foul on Marley. Porter now with 19 points. He's 7 of 10 from the range from outside. Hit his first two threes before he missed one. Barkley retrieves, hits the side of the backboard. Right now, Suns are not getting good shots. Off it comes. Bryant in trouble, and he's fouled. Boy, he hit the deck hard. That's going to be on Barkley second. The Suns right now are really out of sync.
They have taken about three straight bad shots. This is not a good shot by Charles. It's a contested three from the corner. They need a better possession than this. Long shots, long rebounds. Strickland, again, what do you do with him? You run the fast break. The fourth man down is the dangerous man. Mark Bryant drew the foul, and it's one of those little surges that we talked about.
Now Barkley's got a technical.
I told you it was coming. You know, I knew it was coming. It just was a matter of time when he was going to get it tonight.
Well, Westfall got one earlier, and now Charles Barkley gets one, and Porter, who shot the technical free throw earlier, will attempt one here.
Since the Suns have to be very careful right now. Portland has a chance to push this lead out to 9. If Porter's able to convert this and Bryant makes both of his.
20 points now for Porter. Barkley derisive clapping there as though he's happy he got that technical. I tell you, though, in talking to him, he figures this is his best chance ever to win a championship. And he said, I don't want to mess it up. He has that playoff look, and right now he's got a look at Tommy Wood that would kill.
Yeah, Tommy is getting the old one-eyed stare right now from Charles Barkley.
I hope he's looking at Tommy, not you and me.
Well, I think Tommy Wood is doing the smart thing. He's sort of backed away from Charles. Charles does not want to get ejected at this point in time.
Bryant able to hit that free throw. Bryant is shooting 70% from the line this year. He's the former first-round draft pick in 88, 21st pick for these Blazers, and has started the last 21 games. West hung up there with Kersey. It's getting physical now.
Yeah, well, you see the game is starting now to play. Some defense is being played. In the first half, it was run up and down, take your turn getting a good shot. Now all shots are being contested. There's another tough shot by Kevin Johnson.
The Suns are 1 of 8 in this quarter shooting after those two misses. A loose ball foul. It'll be on Barkley. It's the third. Let's take this opportunity now at tonight's Chevrolet scoreboard. We talked about Chicago, Detroit, how big that game is. How about Houston? They're going for the 11th straight win.
Bad break, though. Vernon Maxwell with a broken bone in his wrist. He'll be out for a while. San Antonio up 17. It looks like they're going to be in a position to clinch that fifth spot before tonight's over.
And play these Portland Trailblazers in the first round. Third foul on Barkley. As I mentioned, the Suns are 1 of 8 in this quarter, shooting the ball from the field. Strickland. Inside, Oliver Miller's check in. Buck Williams, good creation that time by Rod Strickland, getting the assist. And the Suns are going to call a timeout. They're on a 10-0 run, the Trailblazers. And they enjoy a 10-point lead. 6:35 to go in the third. And the Suns right now struggling. They've lost their composure.
Choosing your first new car sure can be complicated. There are cars that promise you safety. Cars that are well-built and well-backed. Cars that won't leave you stranded. Cars that give you a break on the price. Even cars that help with your down payment. But Chevrolet makes it easy to get all of the above. In the Chevy Cavalier, the lowest-priced car in America with standard anti-lock brakes. Test drive Chevy Cavalier today at your neighborhood Chevrolet.
What's DMX? It's Digital Music Express from TCI Cablevision. You know, the cable guy.
With DMX, you get 30 channels of digital CD quality music pumped right through your cable into your stereo. You don't need a CD player, just basic cable. Then enjoy non-stop music, no commercials, no talk, just music. And it's brought to you by TCI Cablevision. Call now and get it.
Soft Hits, FM 105.3. FM 105.3.
FM 105.3. Don't let the sun catch you crying.
All day long, the Tri-Cities' newest radio station, Soft Hits, FM 105.3.
For the crown for the ninth consecutive season. TNT Sports will be the home of the NBA playoffs. All the action begins next Thursday at 8 p.m. Well, right now, the Blazers are playing like they're in the playoffs. They have outscored the Suns 10-0 in the last 3:05 of this third quarter. Another turnover. Suns didn't have a turnover in the first quarter. Now have started to turn over. They have 10 for the game. Robinson missing. They're getting all the loose balls right now.
They're just out hustling right now. They're more focused.
And nice effort by Barkley, and it went off of Buck Williams. Heads up play by Barkley to keep that ball from getting to the baseline for an easy two.
Well, Phoenix has a tendency sometimes to get distracted, and they go through those stretches. They're one for their last eight. They had a turnover the last possession. So we talk about that little five-minute little skirmish. Well, in that four-minute skirmish that's happened right now, they're losing 10-0.
Off it comes to Barkley. Bryant jumps out on him. Marley's been very quiet. He had 11 points in that first quarter. Barkley to pull one up, and they needed that. That stops the bleeding momentarily for this Phoenix team, who have been outscored 10-0. Gets around Ainge, puts one up, gets the shooter's bounce. Looks like he caught something in his face that time, and he released the ball. No foul, but the basket going for Porter.
I think Danny Ainge caught him as he took the ball to the basket. Boy, Kevin Johnson cannot buy a shot.
He cannot. He is now 2 of 10 from the field. Well, you know, Phoenix, looking at the playoffs, has had a tough time on the road. They have not won here. They have not won in Los Angeles. They haven't won in Seattle. And, of course, all those teams in the playoffs, and the Rockets, a team that embarrassed them Monday night at home.
Well, when you look at that, the one thing that does stand out is they're 12-2 against Eastern Conference teams on the road that are going to be in the playoffs. So they played exceptionally well anytime they went on the road trip going to the East.
Good ball movement off to Buck Williams. 5:10 to go now in this third quarter. 10-point lead, and we have a foul against the Suns on the move inside by Buck Williams. Foul is going to go on Ainge. It will be his second. That's a 15 foul now against Phoenix, with still over 5 minutes to go in this quarter.
You know, on the season, when you look at Phoenix's numbers, it's very interesting. Their opponents have 9 more field goals on the season. Phoenix has 138 more three-point shots. But when you think, when you take 1,059 three-point shots, you wouldn't get to the foul line. Just to the contrary, Phoenix has 325 more free throws than their opponents, so they have been able to combine getting inside and getting to the free throw line with their three-point shooting. So I think that's been one of their abilities this year, to be able to spread the defense, and the ability of Ainge and Marley to shoot the long-range shot and then go inside to Barkley posting.
Kevin Johnson, 2 of 10 from the field, takes it inside and he's fouled. The question I always have, Doug, are the threes there in the playoffs like they are in the regular season?
Well, it depends on how teams are going to play defensively. Are they going to force you to beat them from outside? Are they going to make the commitment to double-team Charles Barkley? I think you have to be very careful. When you make a commitment to double-team Charles Barkley, you're either going to free up Sabalas and Dumas slash into the basket, or Chambers, or you're going to spot up one of your open three-point shooters. So you have to make a decision on what you want to do, and I think you have to stay with it. If you're going to make Barkley score, I think you've got to do it for 48 minutes. I don't think you can change in the middle of the screen and then let these other guys get going.
See the numbers on KJ. As you know, he's been on the injured list twice. He's missed 29 games due to injuries or coaches' decisions not to play him back-to-back. So it's been tough for him to get the continuity, but he did lead him in scoring Monday night with 18. That's a nice spinning move by Kevin Duckworth, who looked very shaky in the first half.
He took his time. It was very good patience. He took the ball right to where he wanted it, made the nice little jump hook over the top of Oliver Miller's outstretched arm.
12-point lead now for Portland. Barkley wanting to back in. Gets it out to Marley. Marley's been very quiet. That'll start him up. A three from outside.
That was the double team, and Marley worked right in behind him and got to the open spot. That's 4 threes now for Marley in the game.
In 4 attempts, 4 for 4. Here's Porter. He'll attempt the three. Williams tries to keep it alive, and it's going to be off of Phoenix. It'll be Portland's basketball.
Ball goes inside to Barkley. Here comes the double team over. Here comes Duckworth, so you got to rotate. Marley works right in behind and gets the open three. That's what happens when you make the double team.
And his first point since the first quarter. He has 14 for the game, 11 in the first quarter. Kevin Duckworth, Oliver Miller rips it down. The rookie out of Arkansas, who's lost close to 40 pounds this year. Restricted diet, they checked him into the hospital, got that weight down. Now he's hired a cook to cook for him at home, and we're going to have a foul inside on Kevin Duckworth. So Kevin Johnson still playing hard, even though the shots are not going for him. He is 2 of 10. He has 6 points, but 11 assists.
Yeah, we have to look at his assists, what he does when he gets inside. I think what's happened tonight is Kevin's got caught in the air, and the defense has stepped back into the passing lane in this third period, and he's had to force some tough shots. So I can count at least 3 shots in this quarter that he's had to jackknife to get it up there and had really no chance to get it in.
Dumas comes in. Danny Ainge checks out. Oliver Miller wide open. He hit those in the first half. A little further out the time. Lost control of it. Here come the Blazers. 82-73 Portland. 3:38 to go in the third. A 10-0 surge for Portland has been the big surge in the ballgame. Duckworth with another little jump hook. He's playing with different confidence in the second half.
He just powered into Oliver Miller, who got knocked back onto his heels, then could not jump to defend the shot.
Charles Barkley thought about taking the 2 from outside.
Now watch Marley for the 3 if Porter helps.
8 seconds on the shot clock. Barkley takes it in. He's fouled. Kevin Duckworth's made 2 very impressive moves inside.
Watch how he used his body here. He's going to go in and watch the bump right there. See him knock him on his heels. When he does, he gets the room to make the shot. Oliver Miller, when the man starts to back, you've got to brace yourself. You've got to get your legs down, and you've got to be able to push back. So now if the guy starts to jump, you can go up and defend the shot. When you get back on your heels, there's no way you can get up to jump.
Or when you weigh 280 pounds like Duckworth is, 7 foot, it's hard not to be put back on your heels, isn't it?
Well, what you have to do, Gary, is you have to sort of deliver the blow. You have to use the forearm bar, and you have to sort of put it in the guy's back and push at him before he can get his body on you.
We'll be back.
When it's this hot, don't take chances. Only Armor All Protectant guarantees your new car's dash from cracking. There is a fountain of youth, and we guarantee it. Armor All.
From the nation's capital, the McLaughlin Group.
Issue 1, the NBA, your dream fast break team, Fred Bond.
Barkley rips down the rebound and fires to Kevin Johnson.
Johnson dribbles it across half court and whips it over to Mullen in the corner.
Mullen considers a 3-pointer, spots the mailman underneath.
Mailman, right, mailman.
Well, rejected by McLaughlin, who throws an 85-foot prayer.
He winds up, fires it, good!
I love this game.
My, oh my, that's an exclamation point.
Dutch Boy Paint is now on sale. Dutch Boy Paint is now on sale at Sears. Regularly priced at $17.99, Dutch Boy's Kids Room Paint is now on sale for only $12.99 a gallon at Sears.
Ten-point lead for Portland. The 93 NBA playoff preview show will be coming up on TNT. That'll begin 8 o'clock on Sunday night. Ernie Johnson will be in our Atlanta studios. Doug Collins, Juby Brown to break down the playoff matchups. Craig Sager will be in New York reporting on the Bulls' Knicks game. And they'll talk to Chuck Daly from Detroit following the Nets game with the Pistons. That's a preview show, and you get that sense of anticipation. And the Portland Trail Blazers,
well, they're going to rub it in. The world champions. That's the year that we were up 2-0 when I was in Philly, and they came back and beat us 4 straight.
1977. That was the Bill Walton team. You know what? They did not have a home court advantage going into the playoffs that year.
No, but they played well during that playoff period of time. I think they beat Chicago in an unbelievable best of 3. Yeah. Then they beat the Lakers. They were playing great. There was some time off in between the series, and then we jumped on them 2-0, and then they came back and was able to win the next 4 games after a fight in game 2 when Darryl Dawkins and Maurice Lucas got into it, and I thought changed the whole tempo of the playoff series.
Well, Barkley had a free throw before the timeout. He's got another one coming. He can cut it to 9. Are the Suns capable of a surge similar to what Portland threw at them here in this third quarter?
Well, they're going to have to do it with defense. You defend and you get some easy scores. They're not going to be able to trade baskets. So let's see if they can do now what Portland did, is make them take some tough shots.
Barkley backside trying to come up with a steal. A pass in him for Robinson. I think it was Dumas who committed the foul as he reached in.
Well, Barkley had that play read perfectly from the weak side. He came and was able to get the steal, but Dumas had committed the foul before Barkley was able to make the theft to go to the other end. And Cliff Robinson on the free throw line, where Portland owns a decided edge. That's 20 for 26 now on the ball game. 7 for 14 for Phoenix, so plus 13 at the foul line. They're winning by now 11, plus 14 from the foul line. So the difference is their ability to get to the free throw line. Phoenix shooting only 50% tonight at 7 for 14.
Phoenix started out missing their first six. They were 1 of 8 at one time from the free throw line. Dumas has been very quiet, trying to come back from the severe ankle sprain that kept him out for most of the month of March, and he is fouled as he goes baseline. Dumas is one of those guys with great anticipation who can slash very well. He's really missed Charles Barkley not being in the lineup.
Yeah, and right now he's feeling himself back in. He's, I think, over-penetrating. He had a wide open, about 10-foot jump shot. Tip Robinson had backed off of him. He was determined to get to the basket. A good block shot from the weak side, but the foul was called with the body. And I think Richard Dumas has to be very careful that he doesn't run away from his jump shot, because what makes him a different player from Sabalas is he's a better shooter than Cedric Sabalas. So he does not want to forget that the local jump shot, because that brings a lot of different problems to the game than rather than taking it and going on the drive to the basket.
I sense that Dumas is getting the ball in different places, different looks with Barkley out of there. Now with Barkley back, he may get back to some familiarity in this game where he played so well. He was averaging almost 21 points a game before he got hurt. Delper tried to follow on that, misjudged it. Out it comes to Kevin Johnson. Johnson ducks all the way in, got it. So Kevin Johnson, even though he's not been shooting well, able to get that one. He has 8 points in the ball game, and now the Suns trying to put together a little push here. Ellie with a tough shot.
Fading baseline, looked like he was behind the basket. The fortunate thing for him was his right hand was closest to the basket as he was fading. Had he been a left-handed player, there's no way he could have gotten that shot down. He would have hit the back of the basket.
Well, that's easy. Those New York playgrounds, they have to compute the wind. He didn't even have to do that tonight.
That's right.
Marley tries to follow his own shot. Rebound, Dumas. Good hustle by the Suns. Dumas, good second effort. And the Suns now trying to battle back in this one, down by 88-81. Porter off to Duckwood. Duckwood wide open. Dumas jumps out on him. Rebound, Barkley. Suns now playing with some confidence. That's 6 rebounds for Sir Charles. He'll take it all the way, uncontested. And Barkley now has cut it to 5. Porter trying to take KJ baseline. A little off balance. He traveled. Jake O'Donnell on top of that one. Felt he shuffled the feet. The turnover gives it to Phoenix.
When Charles Barkley gets the ball on the defensive backboard and pushes the ball out, he's almost impossible to stop in the open court. Who's going to take a charge on this man? Here he is. He's a runaway locomotive. Kevin Porter says, I don't think so. I think I give up the 2 points. It's about playoff time, and I do not want to be incapacitated.
Well, they were down by 12. They've cut it to 5. Nice give and go to Dumas. Dumas is fouled as he tried to duck in. Clint Robinson made contact. Dumas right now is playing very hard, overcoming maybe being a little tentative early in the ballgame.
Gary, the one thing about Portland, and this is something that's been a character trait of this team, is that they go through droughts offensively. And when they do that, teams can come back against them. They've had a nice lead here. It was up to 11 points. And Phoenix, with some nice defense, has been able to chip away at it. It's now down to 5 with the ability here if Dumas makes a free throw to cut it to 4. But Portland has a tendency, because they're not a great shooting team, to go through 4 or 5 minute periods of time where if you will defend and rebound, you have a chance to get right back into the game.
Dumas, they better shoot some free throws. They're 9 of 18, 50% from the line. You saw Dumas a moment ago. It's 2 of 5, now 2 of 6. When you go on the road, you've got to hit those free throws.
Especially when you're trying to come back after an 11-point deficit.
Here is Duckworth playing with a different kind of tenacity. The first half, he didn't look like he really wanted to shoot the ball. Now he wants the ball. 7-point lead for Portland. Kevin ducks in and got it. He's fouled. What an explosive first step that was.
Boy, Rod Strickland is a quick player, too, and Kevin Johnson left him standing. This was a Tim Hardaway crossover, right to left, and then the nice finish actually between his legs, and there's the nice finish. He threw his body in there and then was able to kiss the ball off the glass with the proper spin.
10 points, 11 assists for Kevin Johnson, who continues to play hard even though he didn't have the success shooting-wise early in this ball game. 4-point game, 38 seconds left in the quarter. Robinson tries to go baseline on Chambers. He cuts it off. 11 seconds on the shot clock, 27 on the game. Back out to Duckworth. Duckworth, all 7 foot up, blocked by Oliver Miller. Ellie to put it on the way. The shot clock expires. Dumas comes down with a rebound.
She gets the last shot here. The shot clock is off. Only 12 seconds to go.
Marley to try another three. Doesn't get it. Rebound Robinson. As we have 5 seconds left in the quarter.
Boy, Marley's mad at himself. I read his lips and said, I had a wide open three. I got to make that one.
He hurried it a little bit, though. As Kevin now with the interception, he'll have another chance at a three. Further away, almost got it. That would have counted. So the Suns, after trailing by 12 in this quarter, battle back to cut it to four. We have 12 minutes to go from Portland.
It's out there, waiting for you. A whole world of possibilities. And there's only one vehicle that can take you there with so much style and so much room. Chevy Suburban. There's nothing quite like it on Earth.
Green, had a problem. Nobody knows what to wear with me, he said. I'm tired of not fitting in. Fortunately, Dockers had the solution. From cactus green and olive, evergreen to loden, we made shades of green that went with just about everything. Now Green's got a new problem. Says he's feeling overworked. Should have expected it. Nobody does green like Dockers.
The NBA playoffs on TNT.
You want to see your favorite teams. You want to know what's going on in all the games.
If there's a break in the action, you want to see another game.
You want to hear what your favorite players have to say.
You want it delivered by people who really love this game.
You want it all.
You want the NBA playoffs on TNT.
Why? Because
nobody plays the playoffs like TNT.
Nobody.
The playoffs begin Thursday, April 29th on
TNT.
Saturday on TNT.
My daughter and I deliberately chose this vessel. We're tired of the super gloss and luxury of the cruise liners.
TNT nets an entire evening of five frightening sea monster flicks that will shiver your timbers. Overgrown octopuses, giant gators, colossal crabs, and super sauruses. The kind of stuff every sea epic should have. Monster Visions, Attack of the Sea Monsters. All night Saturday, beginning 10 Eastern on TNT.
The Blazers, who led by as many as 12, had their lead cut to four as we came to the end of that third quarter. And Doug Collins, 11 points different from the free throw line. That's a big difference in this ball game for Portland.
Yeah, and the fact that Phoenix is shooting so poorly, they did get to the free throw line in that quarter, but they just weren't able to shoot the very high percentage. Kevin Johnson came to life with some great drives to the hoop late in that period to bring his team back.
Tom Chambers doesn't get it. Rebound Robinson. Just underway, fourth quarter. First rebound, by the way, for Robinson. Do you believe that in this ball game? Maybe change that color of the sweatband. That made the difference as he uses a glass there.
Well, he's been very quiet on the offensive end. He's 3-for-10 on the ball game. Has gotten to the line 4-for-4, but
Chambers reverse blocked by Robinson. Excellent, excellent defensive play. Strickland kicks it out to Duckworth. Ellie will duck inside. Look at that power move. Chambers with the rebound. Boy, Ellie goes up so powerfully on that play. Up it comes to Dumas. Can't control it. It'll be off of Phoenix.
That was a tough pass to handle. I know Kevin is a little bit upset at Richard Dumas. He goes over and, you know, tells bad pass, but it was a little bit behind him and very difficult to handle.
With Robinson from outside, and maybe not an advised shot at this stage of the game for Portland.
I agree. That's a shot that he can get at any point in time, especially with 20 seconds on the shot clock.
Dumas kicks it out to Miller. Marley, who's missed his last two threes, hits one here. That's his fifth of the game.
What a weapon. What a weapon. That just sticks a dagger right through your heart when one of those three goes in like that.
5 of 7 from three-point land. He started the game with 11 points the first quarter. Now Portland turns it over with 10:32 left in the ball game. As Sabonis now will come into the Phoenix lineup. Jake O'Donnell saying, wait a minute. You can't come in yet, so he'll wait on the scorer's table.
See, I think this is a very important game for both these teams to try to win. Phoenix wants to get that feeling back of winning after losing four of the last five, and Portland on their home court, knowing they could face this team, wants to be able to finish this game off after really controlling it through the third quarter.
Suns have got it to three. Kevin Johnson kicks it. Nice pass to Marlin. I'll tell you, Oliver Miller really has a good understanding of the game.
Great feel. He felt the cutter coming right by him. The little touch pass. The big guy's got soft hands.
Yep. And Barkley was even impressed. Talking to him last night, how well he sees things. There is Marley. Good effort defensively. Comes up with it to Johnson. Dumas with a slam dunk. And a 12-point lead has been extinguished. And the Suns lead it by one. 93-92 with 9:51. You said the surge would have to come defensively, and that's what happened.
The strong double team by Marley. Here's the give and go in the finish. Great play.
The United States Navy wants him put away. And Jack Nicholson makes sure he goes out in style. In The Last Detail, tonight on TNT.
NBA playoffs are coming to TNT. Are you ready?
Yes!
Who's playing who? Who's got the edge? Who's got the talent?
You want it all.
Get all the answers from the experts on the NBA Playoff Preview Special, Sunday at 8 on TNT.
Thank you. Pull around.
Thank you.
Paul Coughlin, call the Big
That's
L 93.
Me.
In the next 93 seconds, you'll be today's
yes.
big winner.
I need a phone.
Because what you want is lunch in minutes. Our crew really hustles for you. So now, what you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Paul, you still have 24 seconds. Call, babe.
This will take a minute.
Hey, Paul, you out there, buddy?
Introducing the exciting new Subaru Impreza Sportwagon. All 110 cubic feet of it. That's like the size of four sleeping bags, luggage, a 20-pound sack of potatoes, three bags of groceries, a portable barbecue, and a family of four. Hey, everybody needs their own space. The new roomy Impreza Sportwagon from Subaru. It's not just another new car.
Here's tonight's Dutch boy in the paint, and when the Suns rebound well, they are a good basketball team. They're 42-4, and they out-rebound their opponent.
Well, they're plus two, and they're making up for the difference at the free throw line with some excellent defense in this last little segment. Points in the paint, Blazers 48-42.
Look at this surge, Doug. In the last 5 minutes and 7 seconds, the Suns have outscored the Blazers 18-6.
And they've done it with defense, deflections. They've gotten out to the open court, gotten some easy scores, and that's what you have to do. Now, Portland's got to come out of this timeout, and they've got to get themselves an easy score. Now, who do you go to? I say Cliff Robinson.
Robinson has Chambers on him as he's baseline to the left side. Kicks out to Ellie. Ellie will give it back to Strickland. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Changed his shot. Doesn't get the roll. And it comes out to Sabalas. To Marley. Back is Ellie. Here's Kevin Johnson to the hole with it.
What a play by Kevin Johnson. He caught that ball and put it on the floor with his left hand. Wrapped it around like he was going to throw a behind-the-back pass. Kept it and finished it with his left hand. Remember now, he's a right-handed player, so that was a sensational play.
And he got smacked in the snaz as he went in, too. He's still checking to see if it's still there. Here's Bryant baseline. The basket will count, and he's fouled. Let's go back to the Kevin Johnson play. Let's look at it.
He's going to get the ball. Watch it. He wraps it around. You really couldn't see it as well as we could from a different angle. And this is the nice play. Mark Bryant with a pump fake. He gets Oliver Miller in the air. And Oliver, you got to understand, when you get airborne like that, grab a guy's arms so he cannot finish the shot. These guys in the NBA are magicians when they're fouled about being able to concentrate and finish. So if you're going to give up a two, make sure it's from the free throw line, not a touch three-point play.
And that three-point play tied it up. That was Oliver Miller's fourth foul. 95 all, less than 9 minutes to go now, just inside nine. Kevin Johnson penetrating, dishing, gets it off to Miller. Kevin Johnson right now has ignited this team with his penetration moves.
He's getting inside. That's at least 13 or 14 assists now in the game. I think 13 assists, 11 in the first half.
13, that's right. 97-95, the Suns, 8.5 to go in the game. Ellie, baseline, weaves inside to Bryant. Bryant tries to reload it. Good second effort by the Seton Hall product. Staying with it. Good tenacity. It's even at 97.
And so you've got Terry Porter resting for Portland, so he's going to come back to finish, so give them some offense. And you have Barkley resting right now. for the Phoenix Suns, so he's going to be able to come back strong. So we'll have to see in resting their players who's going to be in the best position to win the game.
Don Chambers backing in now, has it slapped away, reloads it, doesn't get it. Cliff Robinson kept it alive to Duckworth. And now the Blazers have a chance to take the lead. Strickland takes Kevin Johnson inside. Oliver Miller, the sweeping rebound.
That's Marley for three.
Seven rebounds for Oliver. Sabonis had it blocked.
Oh, that's a goaltend. They missed that one. That's
and
West a goaltend.
Ball is up. He's mad. Off to Duckworth. And Duckworth is fouled. And Kevin Johnson hits hard as he went over the top of him. And Kevin Johnson's angry. Look at him. He felt at the other end there should have been goaltending.
Lee Jones was not in a position to call this. He's underneath the basket. That's got to be from the trail official. That ball was off the backboard. It's going to be a technical on Kevin Johnson.
That's the third technical tonight against the Suns. Westfall, Barkley, and now Kevin. But Kevin had a legitimate beat. It was goaltending. We're going to look at it here. Watch it.
All right,
it.
Now watch the ball here. It's going to go off the backboard. Right there, and then it's tipped. That was easy to see. I'm really surprised they missed that one.
Mark Bryant.
Here's the ball. It's above the cylinder. And there's the ball that's slapped off the backboard.
So Kevin Johnson with the technical. Ellie to shoot the technical foul. One-point lead for Portland. So Kevin now sitting down. Miguel Knight has come in.
That's one of the reasons why you always try to teach your young people or your players, your power players, anytime you're around the basket, dunk the ball. Anytime you give a guy an opportunity to lay the ball off the basket or off the backboard, you got a chance for a block shot.
Immediately following this, stay with us for Inside the NBA with Fred Hickman. Tonight's action, a look at the Bulls drive for three-peat as Kevin Duckworth makes it a 197 game in favor of Portland. Let's see how the Suns react with 7:38 left in the game.
Well, if they double-team Barkley, now remember Ainge. Ellie cannot leave Ainge, or it's not Ainge, but Marley for the three.
Miguel Knight gets it off. Tough pass inside to Sabonis. They turn it over. Miguel Knight has not been shooting all that well. He's shooting 40% from the field, and that was a tough short pass to Sabonis to try to come up with.
Well, I remember about 2 years ago, Miguel Knight played sensational basketball in the absence of Kevin Johnson. And then he got hurt, and he really never has been the same player. They've been very fortunate that Frankie Johnson has been able to give them a lot of quality minutes this year, but Miguel Knight has really never recovered from his injury.
Well, Frankie Johnson was hurt Monday night. He had a bruise and scratched cornea. Not playing tonight, so Miguel is in there. Out the comes to Ellie. Ellie with a hustle move. Got it.
Is running away from loose balls. The ball is bouncing there, and you've got guys running out to score. You must first recover the deflection before you can run out and get the score on the other end. So they've got to get to the loose ball.
7-0 run right now by Portland, and Barkley stops that. So Charles Barkley, the go-to guy, bringing it back a little bit now. He's cut it to three. Well, they goaltending call really distracted Phoenix, and now we have Marley baseline tangle up with Ellie. It's going to be on Mark Bryant, the foul away from the ball. That will be his fourth.
Barkley with a fadeaway jump shot. He and Mark Bryant working hard in the post. There's a little bump in the fadeaway. The old momentum stopper, Charles, going to the patented fadeaway jumper.
And Barkley trying to bring it back, puts that one up a little too soft. Rebound cleared by Kersey.
How long will Rick Adelman wait to come back with Terry Porter? We have just over 6 minutes.
How long do you keep Kevin Johnson out of there?
Well, I think maybe about another minute.
Strickland cut off by Miguel Knight. 6 minutes to go in the game. Splits the defenders. Gets out of real trouble. 3 seconds on the shot clock, and Barkley commits a foul. That is his fourth. Williams comes in now, replacing Mark Bryant, who will sit down, and the crowd really appreciating his hustle.
Well, three team fouls now on Phoenix, so they only have two more before the Portland Trailblazers will be shooting in the penalty.
And Portland hasn't committed a one.
And which is very important, because late in the game, when you're going to have to play Charles, you're going to have to bump him, and you want to be able to have a couple fouls to waste before you put him on the foul line.
Robinson, they stop it, wave it off. Jake O'Donnell, 3 second lane violation. The basket doesn't count.
It's what happens when you pass up an open shot. Your rebounder expects you to take the shot, so he's getting possession. You take up the extra dribble, and you catch the guy in the lane with a 3 point or the 3 second violation.
Suns down by three. 5.5 minutes left in the ball game. Barkley is fouled as they try to get the entry pass. Buck Williams reaching across his fourth. See Chicago leading the Pistons. Houston winning their 11th straight, it appears. San Antonio, who will be playing these Portland Trail Blazers, they win that ball game, leading the Nuggets. 102-99 this one. Into Barkley again. Miguel Knight from outside doesn't get it. Sabalas follows, can't get that, and the rebound ripped down by Buck Williams. Stolen by Sabalas. And you can tell these Trailblazer fans didn't like that development. It's a one-point game.
Meaningless regular season game, right?
Yeah. No emotion here, Doug. Absolutely none.
There's a double team on Cliff Robinson. Let's see if he can find the open man.
Nope, they threw it away. Intended for Strickland. It hit Tommy Wood, the referee, and Rick Adelman feeling that Wood got in the way.
Watch the steal. Here's the great rebound by Buck Williams, and then the Sabalas knocking the ball loose, and there's the nice finish to bring Suns within one. Now, what happened in this last possession is on the double team, Tommy Wood was standing out of bounds. The ball was bounced out to Mario Elie, and it hit Tommy Wood standing out of bounds. The referee's part of the play, yeah. So that's considered out of bounds.
And Adam at the other end didn't like it. That foul on Elie is now, Porter needs 6 points to reach 10,000. We understand if, in fact, he gets it tonight, they'll stop the ball game and give him the ball. Right now, a one-point game into Barkley. 4:44 left.
This is the important place where you have to have some fouls to waste. So if he gets in a position, you have to take a foul. They'll just sideline the ball out.
There's goaltending. They got that one. Robinson, there's what Barkley does so well, Doug. They double down on him in a slashing move by Sabalas.
That's why I think you make a serious mistake if you double-team Charles Barkley too much, because instead of forcing Charles to make shots, you allow Sabalas, Dumas, these other players to slash to the basket and get layups. Now, they end up getting their 20 points, and Charles ends up getting his also, so everyone's involved. Yep. I think it's a tough situation, a tough decision that you have to make. Maybe make Charles go a little one-on-one and look to score himself.
Suns on a 6-0 run, have a one-point lead, 4:22 left. Robinson high, arching one-hander. Barkley rips down the defensive board. 7 rebounds for Sir Charles. Kevin Johnson kicks it to Chambers. Chambers buries it. And Barkley went flying in the air.
Tom Chambers is a great shooter, so now they've got the matchup where he's going to play at the center position, but he's actually going to play on the floor offensively as a forward.
Strickland gets a roll. Both teams now throwing their best shots at each other. 1 point lead for Phoenix. Inside, 4 minutes to go.
But look for the ball to go to Barkley, and then he will read the double team.
Inside to Marley. Marley has it ripped away by Kersey. He saves it. Big defensive play by Jerome Kersey. Porter outside with 3:38 to Kersey. Tries to follow inside. Barkley with another board. Boy, Barkley with two big defensive boards. And we have a timeout called by Phoenix.
Timeout.
3:32 left. The Suns with a 1 point lead.
There are very simple things I want from a car. I want a car to run good. I want a car to look good. I like words like reliable, dependable, trustworthy. And I want it to look good. Did I say that already? I want a car I can trust. Does that seem like such a terrible thing? So I bought this new Impreza. It's got everything I just said, and it's a Subaru. I've taken care of things all my life, and I don't want to have to take care of a car. I locked my keys in the car.
1, 105 to 104. Charles Barkley has really played tough on the boards. Here's an effort by Marley, ripped away. Now watch this play.
That's very similar to the play that Kersey made against David Robinson the other night, and then this play now follows it up with Charles Barkley, and he says, go ahead, put your arm in here.
Yep. 23 points, 8 rebounds, 2 big defensive boards here in this fourth quarter. 1-point lead now for Phoenix. Out to Chambers. Chambers in trouble as he cuts inside, but he's fouled. So with 3:13 left to go, here is the game reset. The Suns with 2 full timeouts, the Blazers with 3. Both have a 20-second. Suns have 1 foul to give, the Blazers 2. 105-104 as Chambers goes to the line. And the Suns have not been very good at the free throw line. They're 10 of 19.
All right, Gary, you're Rick Adelman, and you look now defensively and what you have to do against Phoenix. You've got Barkley, you know they're going to go to him and probably get the double team. You have Sabalas, who's going to be a slasher, so you must make sure you pick him up. You've got Marley, who's a three-point shooter, and you have Tom Chambers, who's going to float and get the medium-range shot. So you have to make a decision now on your defensive stand over these last 3 minutes and 12 seconds. What are you going to do when Charles Barkley gets the ball? Because that's what's going to happen over the next 3 minutes.
Boy, Chambers, most of the years, led the team in free throw shooting. He's lost that lead to Ainge, but he was shooting 84% coming into this ballgame. 3-point lead now for the Suns. Less than 3 to go. Strickland changed the shot, got it.
Ron Strickland's playing a great game. He really is playing as well as he has played any time in his career, playing with great confidence, and is now the leader, the floor general of this team.
Had a high of 25 last Sunday against the Spurs, that big win they had. There's a steal by Porter. Porter will take it to the hole. All of a sudden, that 3-point lead has ended up being a 1-point deficit for Phoenix.
Kevin Johnson went to screen roll. Portland defended it perfectly.
Marley off balance, not a good shot, but Sabalas misses the easy one. That's a big miss in this game.
Got to push it. Now watch Porter spotting up for 3. Marley cannot leave him.
Strickland brings it back outside. 16 seconds on the shot clock. A 1-point lead for the Blazers. And Chambers will get the foul, trying to reach around Flip Robinson. That is his third. We mentioned they had the foul to give. They do not have any left now, as with now 2:05 left in the ball game, Danny Ainge will come in for the Suns. Of course, he played here last year with the Portland Trail Blazers, and now Portland calls a timeout.
Who did Danny Ainge go in for? I did not see who sat down. There were 6 guys on the floor, so we have a 20-second timeout. I think Sabalas is going to leave, which now puts 2 3-point shooters on the floor, Marley and Ainge. Chambers, a good open shooter. Really, the guy you would want to make shots in that situation would be a Kevin Johnson. So we'll have to see what Portland now is talking about defensively.
They may have figured Sabalas is getting tired because that easy shot he missed inside.
Here's the nice play by Porter. Kevin Johnson picked up his dribble. Normally, he does not do that. And Porter with an excellent finish. KJ ran in front of him. He has a nice concentration, eyes on the target, never wavered.
So Ainge comes in. So to be Ainge, Barkley, Chambers, Kevin Johnson, and Dan Marley. Not a big lineup as they go down the stretch here with 2:05.
Well, let's watch now the matchup for Phoenix. Danny Ainge is playing Jerome Kersey. So watch now Kersey's offensive rebounding. I don't think they'll try to post Kersey, but Ainge must do a good job of keeping Kersey off the offensive glass.
They set a screen on Marley. Porter uses it, pick and roll. Up it comes, and Robinson at the end of that one buried it.
Well-executed play. The confidence in Flip Robinson. He has not shot well all evening long, but he made that one when they needed it.
3-point lead for the Trailblazers. A minute 40 left. Barkley backing in, the go-to guy. They double down, and Kevin Johnson goes in, and he's fouled. He's upset he didn't get the chance for the 3-point play.
Gary, Barkley puts you in such a tough position. He gets into the post and you make your rotations, and what he is able to do, he's able to hang in the air and at the last moment found Kevin Johnson, who cut to the basket and bailed him out. KJ will shoot 2. I think Charles is talking about the 24-second shot clock.
Well, you can't read it down here. It's malfunctioned again. To the right, it's been working. And Jake O'Donnell says, yeah, I know that. We saw that earlier, but Charles, see, you can see a little gibberish there.
That's not a two-shot foul. I thought KJ got fouled in the
I did, too, because they had two fouls to give, but that should have been a shooting foul. How can that not be?
I don't know.
Chambers from outside a three. Big three by the veteran has tied it up. That was a gutsy outside shot by Tom Chambers.
How many threes is it now for them tonight? Six?
They have six.
Five of them by Marley.
Porter looking inside, a minute 10 to go. All even at 110. They come out and trap him. Kersey trying to go around Ainge. Power move.
Danny Ainge did not slide his feet. Kersey went on the drive, and he reached from behind for the deflection, did not slide his feet.
Two-point lead now for Portland. Barkley backing in on the block against Buck Williams. Two big, strong guys. Barkley doesn't get the bounce. Tipped by Ainge. Rebound, Kersey.
See, I like that. They did not double-team him. They said, Buck, you're going to play him. We're not going to give someone an open shot.
That's 10 rebounds for Kersey, who had a career-high 16 in the last game. You can see how much better he's playing since coming back from injury.
Remember now, Kersey on the offensive boards.
They trap in the corner. Air ball. No, it doesn't count. The shot clock expired. Phoenix's basketball. They're down by two. 19.9 seconds left in the game. Timeout for the Phoenix Suns. Again, that malfunctioning shot clock, I think, was confusing everyone.
And that was dinner for our favorite food critic?
Everything was wonderful.
Something else to drink, monsieur?
Yes. Make it a Bud Light, please.
I'm sorry, monsieur. We have run out.
Really? Well, that does change things a bit, doesn't it?
If you want great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down, make it a Bud Light.
Billy's Chili. Quaint atmosphere.
Is that a tip or did you just lose some change?
Charming service.
My daughter, she's going to college. She needs a car. So we talked. She wanted this, she wanted that, she wanted ABS brakes. She's a very bright girl. So she looked, and she found a new Subaru Impreza. Well, I can't talk to her about a car, because I'm usually the cynic. But this Impreza left me speechless. So now I say things like, aren't you glad I told you about the new Impreza? And she says, Dad, you're employing revisionist history. Like I said, she's a very bright girl.
Presenting a remarkable breakthrough in the area of...
12 seconds left in the game. Danny Ainge trying to shake loose, gets it into Chambers. Chambers, who had a big three earlier, misses the easy one. He gets it back. He puts it up. It goes with 3.7 seconds left. Boy, Tom Chambers has made some big shots down the stretch for this Portland, I should say Phoenix team. He ties it up at 112, and now a big...
Against you, a guy that you really have a difficult time matching up to. Tom Chambers, a terrific scorer throughout his career, but he can make the outside jump shot, as we've seen by the three-pointer. He can get to the free throw line. He can finish around the basket. So when people talk about the importance of having Tom Chambers healthy, this is the reason why. You go into the fourth situation in a critical time, you're down, and Paul Westphal goes with a lineup of Kevin Johnson, Marley and Ainge's three-point shooters with Chambers and Barkley in the post. So you can play screen roll with KJ. Yep. You can post Barkley, and you've got the three-point shooters. So that is a very difficult lineup. What has to happen, though, Gary, is you have to punish them on the other end. So if Tom Chambers is playing a bigger player, you've got to try to post that guy. And the problem is you don't have a guy on Portland that you can have and let him get something going to the basket quickly, maybe create a shot.
Robinson, 2.2, puts it up. Got it, a three. 5/10 of a second left, and the Suns have a timeout.
This will be an exciting series.
Let's go back and listen to this crowd erupt as Robinson buries the three.
Well, Oliver Miller was afraid of Robinson's quickness, so he gave him the outside shot.
So now with 5/10 of a second left,
See, the impressive thing about that play was Cliff Robinson was 4-for-13 on the night when he made that shot. That's the confidence that Portland has in Cliff Robinson now.
That was a two. We thought they were going to give him a three at the time, so the Suns down by one. Let's look at it again.
Again, what happens now, they go into Cliff Robinson, and Miller's got to give him a little room because he's worried about the quickness if he takes the ball to the basket. Backed off of him in just enough time for him to pull the trigger. 0.5 left. Now, the ruling is 0.3 or under. The only thing you can get is a lob.
Yep.
At 0.5, Phoenix can actually get a catch and turn and a shot. So they have enough time if they can run something to free somebody who can catch it and get the quick shot. So 0.3 is only a lob. 0.5, you can get a shot off.
Chambers, who had been so sensational down the stretch with those big shots, but they're still one short. A two by Robinson, not a three. A one-point lead, 0.5 seconds. You can see the Suns have no full timeouts remaining. They do have a 20. Oliver Miller inbound at center court. Marley, Barkley, and Sabalas has come back into the ballgame now for Phoenix.
Now be aware of Charles Barkley. If Sabalas slashes and Barkley steps back, he will shoot the three. You have to be aware of him stepping back quickly and taking a quick three-point shot.
And now Portland dropping back. They're not going to guard Oliver Miller, who's going to inbound the ball. Baseline Sabalas, Barkley puts it up. Does it count? It does!
Jake O'Donnell said it counted!
Jake O'Donnell said it's good!
Oh my goodness, let's watch this!
And Rick Adelman doesn't believe it.
What a play! The ball goes off the basket.
Now unbelievable!
Remember, yeah, remember, the clock does not start till someone touches it.
Yep.
So when it went off the basket, I don't think it had been touched yet.
The Suns have won it. 115-114, a remarkable effort by Charles Barkley. Let's go back and watch this development.
The key is, was it ever touched before it hit the backboard? Was the ball deflected at any point in time? That's when the clock would start. Keep your eye.
That hit the backboard.
That ball was not touched. There's where the clock starts.
That's legitimate.
That is a good play. That was a good call by Jake O'Donnell. The ball. Watch now. Again, is the ball touched? It was not touched. So there the clock starts. Unbelievable shot by Barkley.
And the place just erupts.
Just the way Paul Westphal drew it up.
Yeah. And the Suns end a three-game losing streak and win for the first time here at Memorial Coliseum in Portland. 115-114, and Charles Barkley coming over after that amazing shot. We're going to go to the studio first real quickly. We'll be back with Sir Charles in just a moment. Ernie, it's all yours.
Great stuff out there. And you know something? They kind of joked, hey, just the way Paul Westphal drew it up. But you see, he ran off the court going like this. Maybe he did plan on doing it because the clock does not start until it hits a hand.
No, I think it was a legitimate play. You know, and sometimes you can do things like that. You know, like if you want to throw the ball inbounds and have a situation where you have very little time left, like say 3.6 or 3.3 tenths of a point.